celebrate with the one to watch.
The Ansett Cup, proudly brought to you by Nike. What are you getting ready for? Hold on Commodore Series 2. Drive the pride. Drive the passion. Drive on. Bunnings Warehouse, where lowest prices are just the beginning. Hahn Premium Light. Now that's taste. TAC. And Ansett Australia, official airline to the AFL. Sport takes you to Waverley for the clash between the Kangaroos and Richmond in the first round of the Ansett Australia Cup.
Yes, believe it or not, footy is back. Cool conditions at Waverley Park as we welcome you for the Ansett Cup of the season 2000. It really is a big match between the Kangaroos and Richmond. The fans are out and ready for the start of the season. It's come early this year and the Tigers coming out onto the ground led by Matthew Knights. Reappointed as their captain for the season 2000. Disappointing year for Richmond last year, and under their new coach Danny Frawley, they'll be ready to fire as they take on last year's AFL premiers, the Kangaroos. They bunch and go through the banner, and Matthew Knights, they're leading up the Tigers onto the ground. It really will be interesting to see how this Ansett Cup goes. We welcome you to Waverley Park. It's a new format, some new rules, and a new coach in Danny Frawley. Jared Healy's with me. Jared, good evening.
Good evening, Hutto, and welcome aboard. You've been going great gun at the tennis, and let's hope you have a great start tonight. But the Tigers will be looking for a successful evening under their new coach. He's promised a new direct style of play, but they're up against the Power Brokers, who incredibly look stronger than they did last year with the additions of Lee Culp at number 2, David Kelthorpe, who didn't settle in Brisbane, number 17, Spider Burton, the cult figure from the West, is number 22. And down there at number 39, Ryan Pagan, the son of the coach, makes his debut tonight. And as we have a look at the Tigers lineup, you can see that they've gone in with an experienced team. They're just about at full strength with a couple of welcome additions. Clinton King from Collingwood, a runner and a ball getter, and Leon Cameron expected to start on the half-back line, to start with the Bulldogs over the last decade, and his skill will certainly add some firepower to the defence of the Bullies.
Well, we mentioned a big night for Danny Frawley, and the Dipper caught up with him.
Well, thanks very much. I got myself a new jacket, got myself a new host, and also I got myself a new coach. Well, Danny, only a couple of minutes before we go out there. How are the nerves at the moment?
A little bit toey, Dipper, but really excited. Yeah, no, it's been a long time coming, 3 months, but the boys are really looking forward to this, and what a better night to play against last year premiers. You know, we've got nothing to lose. We're unknown, so yeah. We're looking forward to it.
Well, just take us through your pre-season. I mean, the feel around the club, you know, in the room, it feels very powerful tonight.
Oh, well, I suppose it's 3 months of culmination of hard work, but, you know, we're going to make mistakes. It's only early days, and it's still only January 28th, but we're looking forward to showing the supporters a really exciting brand of football, and one that hopefully a lot of members out there after tonight will get in there and dig deep for the membership drive.
Now, I see you, Leon Cameron, I see Mark Merenda. I mean, that must be very good to have Mark Merenda fit.
Yeah, listen, we look at him as being a recruit for us. Leon Cameron's going to play down back and really set it up for us, and Clinton King also, but even Matthew Knights has had a pre-season, which he hasn't been able to do for the last 3 years. So, listen, we're really excited at this stage with the lack of injuries, and hopefully that'll be the case after tonight's game.
Now, we all start with a fresh slate. Now, come up against North Melbourne, the Kangaroos, I mean, that gives you some indication how the side's travelling.
Oh, well, you won't get a better test than tonight, will you? They're a side that stood the test of time under Dennis Pagan, and he's a master coach, so it's going to be a baptism of fire for me, but I'm really looking forward to, mate.
Well, thanks for joining us, and good luck, and Hutto, back to you.
Thank you, Dipper. Yes, a big test for Danny Frawley tonight against Dennis Pagan. Well, both sides out on the ground. We're ready for the start of the Ansett Cup. We'll be back after the break with all the action. The Kangaroos and the Tigers under Wayne Carey and Matthew Knights.
You start to feel drowsy, you have a choice. Either you pull over immediately, and a power nap of 15 minutes is enough for you to drive on with much less risk. The alternative is to fall asleep at the wheel. It won't replace a good night's sleep, but a 15-minute power nap could save your life.
An insider ready to speak the truth.
I was told,
don't talk.
A reporter who will help him reveal it.
I never left. A source hung out to dry.
Al Pacino, Russell Crowe. The Insider, a Michael Mann film.
For your chance to win one of 30 Ford cars, just collect the tokens every day in your paper, The Herald Sun.
It's my town, it's my paper.
Sid readies for action.
What do you think? Should do the trick. Simple yet casually slutty.
But before tasting Dave's delights, a rich old man drops a bombshell.
He wants to give $10 million to your clinic.
David loses his research money and holds me personally responsible.
More bad news. He's a rich, dirty old man.
To $10 million, you'll spend the next 48 hours together.
What's a girl to do?
Tell him you have a sister.
Providence, Wednesday on 7.
And the Kangaroos going to attack early. And Corey McKernan has taken the mark in the forward pocket. And we'll line it up in the early seconds, this Ansett Cup match between the Kangaroos and Richmond.
And he's going to be able to spend more time in that forward line with the addition of Spider Burton. They certainly have been blessed with a wealth of riches in the big man department after his addition.
Well, I think he's just pushed it across a little bit, through for one behind. Good evening to Ian Robertson.
Yeah, well, it's great to be here, Anthony, and I think there's quite a few supporters that are enthusiastic about the start of the football season for the year 2000. Pretty good crowd, and you've mentioned it in your preliminaries that it's a cool evening, so it's great to see the people. A lot of enthusiasm at the start of the year.
And not surprising to see Leon Cameron kicking off for the Tigers.
Well, it's Matthew Knights with the ball at left half-back for the Tigers. A high kick goes back towards the wing. Capuano tries to get back onto it. Now the Tigers are a chance to break away. Chaffee's little left foot kick. It'll be tidied up. Colbert, his first chance at gathering the Sharon. But it just trickles over in front of Lee Colbert for a boundary throw in. And the ball not quite up to left half forward favouring the Tigers. The Kangaroos have got the first score behind, kicked by Corey McKernan. Now the umpire's found a free kick here. Maybe Lee Colbert being penalised for not making any effort to keep the ball in the field of play, and it will go to Callaway. Callaway's kick lands the ball at half forward. Big strong mark. Capuano, very integral part of the Kangaroos lineup. Handball away to Bell. Bell across the half back line. This is Durkay. His little left foot kick is a beauty. Onto the chest of Clayton. Clayton in towards half forward. The Kangaroos mounting in a promising attack here. Abraham, slippery. Left foot kick towards full forward. Chance for McKernan, strong mark. Second opportunity now for Corey McKernan to post the first goal on the scoreboard for the Kangaroos.
Robbo, also a change has been made by Richmond. I'll give you their bench first. Drakozevic, Gale, Tawney, Timmendale, Proctor, and Rory Hilton's been taken off. And Aaron James has now moved on to Wayne Carey.
Well, the way they moved the ball was just vintage Kangaroos there. Great to see their defence all sweeping back. Capuano took the ball, got it out wide quickly, and it's finished with the first goal of the Ansett competition with Corey McKernan. And what a great mark it was. He played in front. He was a tough one, really, for Scott Turner, who looked to have him in the right position, but just at the last second, he took the front position in strong hands. So a good start there to the reigning premiers of the AFL Coca-Cola series. And they'll be looking to add this Ansett Cup to their tally of successes in recent years.
So the Kangaroos with the opening goal. Corey McKernan already looking dangerous with a couple of marks. Centre bounce, Capuano high again. Knights, well, he shuffled that out, didn't he? Ottens, Bowden on the rebound. Numbers with Richmond though. Callaway dribbling little kick. Narendra out of position. Gee, that could have been a free, and I think the umpire spotted it.
And Hutto, interesting to see Nick Daffy starting up pretty deep in the forward line, not in the midfield. And There is some suggestion that the Tigers under Danny Frawley will be looking for him to become once again a forward, a goal-kicking forward, rather than a midfielder.
Daffy's handball intercepted on this one. Look at the anticipation early in the season. He's lost nothing, has he, Pickett? A couple of bounces. Strides out, long bomb. McKernan this time not in the best position, the ball carrying a bit far and it's out of bounds.
Hello, I'll have this opportunity to say hello. And also,
hello, Robert.
Also, I'll give the Kangaroo bench Rawlings, Scott, Pike, Calthorpe, Matthew Burton and Craig Scholl.
Pretty strong bench, isn't it?
Yeah.
Strong bench, it's a strong team.
Matthew Richardson has started at full forward, been picked up by Mick Martin. Just hasn't been down there as yet.
In that ruck contest, the umpires found a free kick. It'll go to Ottens, and he quickly moves the ball across the goal at which he is defending. The ball gathered here by Turner. Turner looks down the ground and kicks to the one-on-one. And a good mark taken by Harrison from behind Shane Clayton. He looks in towards centre-half back, decides against that and goes long and high. Will land the ball close to the wing. The crumbs at the front of the pack. Gathered for the Tigers by Bowden. Bowden's kick will drop short. And Capuano, that's his third mark across that half-back line to Matthew Capuano. As I said earlier, when he plays well around the middle of the ground and releases McKernan to roam across that full forward line, by gee, they look dangerous.
Deja vu back to September last year against the Blues when Capuano was just so solid across the half-back line early in the match.
King goes in towards the centre. Chaffee has taken the mark. He goes across the half forward line where Ottens is floated down. And his mark will kick from a little more than 50 metres out. Difficult shot at goal.
Also the breeze, Robbo, it's right in his face at the moment. Jerry Hill should talk about the breeze. He did finish the Sydney Hobart race on that wild thing, Jerry.
Yes, we were fortunate enough to survive on the way down to Hobart. The breeze was just a little bit stronger than this, O'Dipper. And a little bit wetter too, but the Tigers have had just four marks so far this match and the Kangaroos are dominating the airspace with nine.
Well, that young fella there has got to be someone to stand up this year, I feel, Brad Ottens. He's promised plenty and his kick lands within scoring range, but back there for the Kangaroos was King. His kick has been marked by the opposite King. We've got David King for the Kangaroos, Clinton King for the Tigers. And in strongly went Abraham, couldn't gather the ball. Durkay must move the ball on when it hits the ground. King, James. Now the umpire's found a free kick and it's going to the Kangaroos by the look of it. So what that was for, I'm sure this new rule is going to cause some confusion, particularly for the fans.
Yeah, King was on his knees and handballed out while he was on his knees, mate.
Okay, thanks, Dipper. Hewitt took the resultant free kick, but it's being brought back. And he will have to repeat the dose. Umpire Chris Mitchell officiating in that area of the ground. And it is Hewitt for the Kangaroos.
Gets them moving into the middle. Oh, hot. He does look a likely type, doesn't he? Lovely leap. Couldn't get hands complete around the footy that time. Powell rode the bump well. Feed it up for Rogers to go out wide. Harrison on the run. Oncoming traffic. Clayton was good. Kept his footing. Chaffee now, under pressure from Carey. Miranda's in front, but he's got Blakey with him. Mr. Reliable knows how to give a little gentle shove and not give away a free kick. Oh, no. It has gone against him. We're in the back. What do you think, Jared?
Well, technically it was there, and I guess early in the season, the umpires are trying to make a mark for themselves, but they've got to do better into the forward line. The Kangaroos are very skilled at massing the numbers around that hot zone and dropping back. And the Tigers have got to get the ball in far more quickly.
Good combination. Clayton on the end of it. High kick. It's bouncing loose. Gaspar. Some space. Oh, it was a wobbly one. Wasn't up the boot. And Carey takes the mark. Open goal square. He's heading in that direction. Hewitt backing back with Gaspar. Clears the pack and just misses.
And you see the inconsistency there, Hutto, with Hewitt also putting the hands on the back and gave only a little shove, but once again, technically, you could say it was there. Brendan Gale, you would expect, will assume a new role this year with Brad Ottens taking over the rucking role for the Tigers, and Brendan Gale will come on and off the bench to be the second man.
Cameron kicks the ball in, and it is taken out wide by Rogers. Rogers' kick with precision has found Ottens close to centre wing. not quite up to that region, but the kick covers that area. Goes between wing and half forward, gathered by Blakey. Left foot kick back towards the centre, and running with the flight of the ball and taking a strong mark was Simpson, not paid. Quickly swooping on the ball was Campbell, not wasting any time, gets it back towards half forward. The big bombing away by the Tigers not working because it's being mopped up by the strength of that half-back line for the Kangaroos. Away goes Durkay, straightens up and goes directly towards Carey. James under pressure, knocks the ball away. Callaway slips through his hands, through his legs, through everything. Powell there for the Tigers. Powell's kick towards half-forward. The ball hits the ground in front of the pack. On top there of Holland was Pickett. And Holland will take the resultant free kick for the Tigers. His kick goes across the half-forward line, leading out. And with just that little bit of extra pace, Matthew Richardson is marked in front of Martin. The short kick in towards the pocket. Chaffee and Durkay. Ball spills to the back. Miranda and Blakey. Blakey through his legs. Intelligent play to Durkay. Durkay goes out towards the wing. Tigers under pressure. James overruns it. David King for the Kangaroos goes in towards half-forward. The ball covers the players in that area. Callaway, hand pass out wide, and Rogers has the chance. Just taps the ball in front of himself and then goes along the boundary line. That kick, he would be hoping for touch, doesn't find it. Brilliant gather by Colbert from the back there of the three-player pack. His kick in towards half forward. Oh, Carey confronted. Is that a free kick? It is against McKernan, was it, Jared?
I think the umpire signalled a push in the back. Chris Mitchell, the experienced umpire of the night. A couple of young umpires officiating, attempting also to eke a career out in AFL football. But I just think we saw there the benefit of this rule. There are some negatives, according to the players and some of the coaches. But down in the Kangaroos' defence, we saw Gary Durkay just knocking the ball on rather than taking, rather than dragging it in and creating some sort of cluster as Corey McKernan draws blood for perhaps the first time this year.
You can see how. Richmond it was that got a free out of that one.
Frank Shoulder replacing, boys.
Richmond got the free kick.
Yep.
Oh, jeez.
Come on, Robert. It's only early, mate.
Makes you wonder, doesn't it? I mean,
it's only January. Don't get stuck into him yet.
Well, Craig Scholes moved the full forward. Turner's coming off and Tawney's picking him up. Now, boys, off the bench.
Well, Matthew Capuano has got the football.
He's had it all evening.
He took the mark, Robbo. It was a lovely mark.
From the free kick.
Goes short. Shannon Grant, target. No free. Bowden trying to squeeze a little kick out there. Kangaroos, look at the Archer. Coming through. His first touch of the night. Pickett. Leading. No mark that time at the back. The Tigers are getting back in defence. Give them some credit. Robbie Powell streaming out of defence. Long kick onto the wing. No one to kick to. No targets across there. All Kangaroos. Harvey wheels around. Got three players inboard. Finds one of them. It's the coach's son. Ryan Pagan. Long kick. And Bell. One of the smallest men on the ground. Flies and takes the mark 50 out. Open goal square. And he just off target. So 1-3-9. That's the Kangaroos and Richmond yet to get on the board, Jared.
Well, as you said, Hutto, the Tigers are doing a pretty good job there. They're facing a stiff breeze here, so they've elected to just contain the Kangaroos, and they're getting some extra players back, and the Kangaroos are just not being able to find a marking target at the moment within scoring range.
Rogers clears it out to the wing. Oh, nice. So he did that well. Takes the mark. Signed a new deal with the club for another 3 years last year. Long kick, Bowden the target. Outnumbered to Capuano. Has been getting back to Daffy. Electrifying off the ground. Mickey Martin leads him to the ball. And one of those big long bombs from Mickey. Gets it out the half back and he finds Archer and they're away.
Got a push, Robert?
I thought that was brilliant body work there by Glenn Archer. Just a little nudge out. Umpire saw it that way. The kick goes to Grant. Grant in the middle of the ground.
Once again, the Tigers just breaking down with that kick deep into the forward line.
They look as though they've got an extra player on the ground at the moment, the Kangaroos. Harvey released, goes towards the court, and that was just tradesman-like stuff by the Kangaroos. Get into the middle of the ground, go as directly and as quickly as you can, and have a guess who's on the end of it. Carey. Wayne Carey is marked only a matter of 10 metres out. The player on the mark is on the end of the square. So you would expect this to be the Kangaroos' second goal, kicked by their captain, Wayne Carey. goes back, and elementary stuff for Carey.
So Wayne Carey's first goal for 2000, the Kangaroos, 2-3-15. Richmond yet to get on the board.
They've been inside the forward 50, Hutto, the Tigers, six times, yet they've yet to have a shot at the goal.
Harrison from Campbell, maybe a chance now. Capuano's been getting back there and doing damage. That time it's Archer. My ball, he says, dribbles it off. Shannon Grant, Tigers leading the way this time out of defence. And there's Leon Cameron in his new stripes. Well, you wouldn't call them stripes, I suppose. So Cameron goes out to the wing, just finds Daffy, who can wheel around off his left boot. It's a searching kick. Richardson well behind Martin. Oh, he dropped it, Mickey. Matthew Richardson wasn't ready for Martin to drop it. Pushing and shoving on 50. Oh, but Mickey wins out Martin. Look at that handball. Out it went to Archer, and they are away. David King is a loose man on half forward. And the loose man taking it is Hewitt. Just a bit of hesitation and he's gone. Just about caught red-handed. Scholl over the top of it. Good teaming up. Tawney just got it out. Gaspar back to Cameron. He can kick either foot. He had no one to kick to on his left, so he kicked it out in his right. Look who he's found. It's Wayne Carey.
Well, he just looks in terrific form even at this early stage of the season. The first match of the Ansett Cup. We did have the Millennium Game, of course, between the Magpies and the Blues on New Year's Eve, but the umpires found a free kick back where the ball came from there on the ground. Now, this has got to be this new rule. Jared, again, getting the nod from Rowan Saws and Jeff Geishan in the box alongside us that that is the case.
That a player on his knees picked the ball up, then got to his feet and handballed it away. Well, under this new rule, that is against the law. And a player who is not on his feet can't take possession. If you're on your knees or on your back or your stomach, you've just got to belt the ball
slap it out.
And it's going to cost them a goal here, you'd expect.
Well, Craig Short, Scholl goes back and kicks the goal. Kangaroos have got their third.
Han Solo. Who's your daddy, mama?
Oh, Mr. Bossman, take me to your...
Let's get it on.
Hello? Hello? Dal, Dal, if you weren't into it, you should have just said so.
Lamb chop.
So the Kangaroos, 3-3. And at the moment, the Tigers, the job ahead of them, into the breeze. Simpson gets the Kangaroos going. Carey outnumbered that time. They got it to ground and Powell can give them something off half-back. Had some space to run in. Out wide, Daffy. Will it sit for him? It does. Dribbling kick. Blakey in front of Verinda. And they really are struggling to get it much past half-forward, Jared. As you said, not being able to have a scoring opportunity yet.
Well, you pay the price. Sorry, Dipper, but you do pay the price if you're dropping an extra one or two back in defence. When the ball comes forward and you bring it forward quickly, you're also going to be outnumbered, and Capuano's dominated across there. Dipper.
Corey McKernan back at full forward and Brendan Gale back on the ground now.
Harrison, a scruffy kick, a high one. Look at Lee Colbert getting pushed away there. Ball hits the ground. Martin paddling it back. Big McNitty's under pressure. He's caught. Just got the handball away. King. Defensive 50. Onto the wing. Oh, from one King to another. Not quite. And well picked up. It was Powell mopping up. And Cameron, who's done pretty well so far, finds Harrison. Probing kick that time. It's a big pack of players, though, isn't it? Almost the mark. The Holland, is he going to play it? No. Go to ground. Callaway. And the umpire will throw it up.
Now, Gasper's doing everything right. He's playing in front, and at this stage, Wayne seems to be a bit stronger upper body for those contests when he's going for a mark.
Colbert a bit stiff that he never got a free kick in that marking contest.
I think Ben Holland may have had justifiable claims on the mark at first and second bite, and I'm not sure anyone else touched it.
So the umpire there, just a replay of that incident. Now, there must be another blood rule here. There's a player coming off the ground back Tawny. Close to the wing. Jason Tawny, is it? And he looks as though he's got a whack in the head.
And number two for the blood rule, but you'll see the umpire will throw the ball up in the air rather than bouncing it. That's also one of the five trial rules that are being experimented with in the early matches in the Ansett Cup.
That would seem to be a fairly common sense thing to accept that, don't you think, Jared? I mean, there's been a lot of discussion about the ability of the umpires to bounce the ball without favouring either ruckman in a contest, but to me it just seems one of the more common sense
Makes
things
sense
that we can adopt.
Yeah.
The ball out near the wing now. Harrison is an ungainly type, Harrison, but he does get the football on quite a lot of occasions in a game. Ben Harrison, that kick by Daffy has been brilliantly marked at the back of Powell by Adam Simpson. He's had a couple of terrific seasons with the Kangaroos. Adam Simpson, Gasper, knocks it to the front of the pack. Gathered by Bell, couldn't quite get the kick away. Scholl's tackle on Daffy was a beauty. Gathered by Knights, little hand pass Hilton. Gets it away. Harrison again. Wider still to Bowden. Bowden able to kick with the left. High, close to the boundary line. No one home there for Richmond.
Just long gone, so isn't it, Robbo?
Well, blind, aren't they?
One from Bowden there, just going up in the air. The Tigers are trying to get Richo into the game. They've pushed him up to the forward 50. Brad Ottens has pushed down to full forward. He's being picked up by Glenn Archer.
Well, that time, the timing not quite there for McKernan. James clearing it away, only as far as Durke, though. Look at the ease, just slips it down a gear and then into acceleration and a long kick. And, well, it was long, but it wasn't very straight.
It wasn't, but great to see him back, Hutto, in the fold at Arden Street. He was lost last year. He went home, we believe, had a few problems he had to sort out, but they've got in his ear again, the Kangaroos, and he's too talented a player to be lost to footy.
We did see a glimpse there of the coach in the coach's box, Dennis Pagan, and at the back of the box, Ross Smith,
yep.
Who was a terrific player with the old North Melbourne Footy Club.
Yeah, he played plenty of state footy as well. Just a real stalwart there in defence. Both back pockets, Dennis Pagan and Ross Smith.
And Tony Elshaw biting the fingernails.
Ball back inside the Kangaroos 50. Look at Carey, got to go against two again. We'll have to all night. Shannon Grant received the handball from Abraham. Has a fair crack at the two. Gee, only just missed.
Jared, just talking about state football, Dale Waitman is out there as a runner for Richmond. Of course, we spent many times with him with a big V on, and what a great player he was.
No doubt, when the Tigers love to have his skill out in the middle of the ground. But just having a look there, a couple of Kangaroo players had their hands in the air, beckoning for that ball at the top of the square.
There's the bloke that Dipper was talking about, the flea. Good on him, trying to give the Tigers a bit of a handout in their quest
for success
this year.
Even though he can't play, Robbo, he's certainly very vocal out there.
Tipper, just how strong is the wind out there?
It certainly has picked up the last 5 or 6 minutes. It really is going towards the North players, as you know. A lot of the players are running under the ball, Hutto.
So the boundary throw in, McKernan can't break away. Matthew Knights tackled by Abraham. Got the hand pass away. Callaway kept his footing and got the kick away, but only as far as Carey. Carey is marked between wing and left half forward. The pass is very good. Onto the chest of Grant. Grant, the Norm Smith medalist from season 1999.
Got him.
And the pass is good. McKernan is marked in the pocket, only 35 metres from goal. Well, it's going to be the problem of 15 other sides in the competition. Capuano doing the ruck work, Hewitt helping out, Matthew Burton recruited from the West, and Corey McKernan, big, strong, can take a mark, loves to kick a goal. How do they man up on Carey and McKernan on that forward line and maybe Archer to slip down there on different occasions? McKernan goes for goal, difficult angle, but he makes the job look a little difficult than it was. McKernan on that occasion missing and registers a behind. As I said earlier, a very healthy crowd here at Waverley. Did hear a little tip too for you fellas to pass on, maybe that we might play some rostered games here, was the information I've got from before the game started.
trying to take over Scotty Palmer's job?
Well, I was told by a worker from Docklands that the Docklands will not be ready. And the information I got from one of my spies out here was that we will have to play some lofted games after the Ansett Cup here at Waverley. That remains to be seen.
Well, as far as service is concerned, the service is absolutely fantastic out here.
No worry about that. It's a magnificent football oval.
The surface, Dipper. I thought you said the service.
And the service.
23, the Kangaroos, Richmond, yet to get on the board. They'd have to do that in the last minute or so, wouldn't they? The ball thrown in, close towards the boundary line. Free kick picked out.
Bronx tears there because the Tiger fans thought that Matthew Knights missed out on a free kick only a minute or so ago when he was taken too high. But I don't think the Tigers will be that disappointed at the moment. I know they haven't got on the board, as you say. They may do well here.
Daffy, quick kick. And just couldn't hang on to it. Hilton will try and keep it in. Dying seconds, they might get a chance. Campbell, is that Page?
Touched.
Just touched off the boot, slapped it out. That's why. Oh, Harvey's kick smothered. Good persistence by the Tigers. That'll go out towards the boundary line. Clever kick on the bounce. Clayton waiting for it. And gee, shrugged the tackle nicely, didn't he? Kept his footing. Long kick up to half forward. McKernan and James, they'll see it over. And the clock will count down.
You wouldn't think there'd be any further score. Right now, the Tigers, I think, would be relatively happy. That there'd have to be a 20-point bonus in this wind, although, having said that, the Kangaroos play into the wind as well as any side I've ever seen.
You don't get too many second chances with Glenn Archer, do you? When Matthew Richardson dropped that mark, Archer was all over it. Incredible. Boundary throw in, and Aaron James being forced to do the ruck work. The ball gathered by Clayton, kicks the ball towards full forward. And Carey's marked it.
No, not Page.
He's marked it. Not Page. So that siren has ended the first term. Ansett Cup 2000. Carey not happy with that. But it will all stand. And at quarter time, the Kangaroos lead 3-5. Richmond yet to score. The goals for the Kangaroos coming from Carey, McKernan and Craig Scholl.
They've got to find someone to take a contested mark, the Tigers, particularly up forward. The Kangaroos now have nine, with Capuano having three, and Carey and McKernan two apiece. The Tigers only had two contested marks.
So a tough initiation for Danny Frawley, back with a second quarter shortly.
Tonight's weather update, brought to you by...
Thanks, Mum.
Good evening. The cool spell continues, although warmer weather is likely on Sunday. Dry and sunny in the northern half of the state. Elsewhere, some morning drizzle is likely near the coast, and we can expect partly cloudy conditions tomorrow. As for Melbourne, fine after some early morning drizzle. Should be mostly sunny afternoon with a top of 21. Sunday, dry and sunny, a little warmer too, about 25. Monday, continuing fine with a top of 27.
What happened to Brendan's party?
Brendan's dad? Where is everyone?
Out or in bed.
Smells good. What is it?
Teriyaki stir fry.
I forgot these.
Thank goodness you're here.
Sam? Yum. Hey, Mum, I can do this.
That's good. There's another packet in the freezer.
Create a teriyaki stir fry in 15 minutes.
Thanks, Mum.
If you love your AFL footy, then it's time to put your money where your mouth is in the Ansett Club Membership Competition. Become a paid-up member of your club now and you could win tickets to the Grand Final, the Brownlow Presentation and four interstate games. Join up, then watch the Ansett Cup and answer the trivia questions to be in the running. Do it for your team, do it for yourself. Call this number now.
Would have been pleased if they could have got the advantage there of a mark being paid.
Ben Holland it was. There's Daffy's kick. Well, I reckon you'd, on what we've seen in previous years, you'd have to just about pay that one.
It's 5 metres, though. You
well,
surely.
Let's hope they're consistent then all year. And there's another free kick picked out.
I think he's actually paid a mark there to Joel Bowden.
Well, if anybody can kick a goal with this breeze, it's this boy here.
Jared, on a piece of paper here, you've got a few of the Tiger boys that you consider to be make or break years. Certainly, Joel Bowden, would include him?
Oh, I don't think so. I think he's a class act. Robbo.
But he needs to give them a bit more,
He's got to take another step up the ladder, but I don't think it's make or break. There'd be 15 other clubs put their hand up if he was made available.
Well, he's kicking from outside 50, and that's a beautiful kick. The Tigers have got their first goal on the board. Sorry, mate.
So Joel Bowden kicks the first goal for Richmond. Very early in the second term, they had no score on the board at quarter time. Matthew Knights tries to get the hand pass away. Forced forward by Bell. Hilton under a bit of pressure, was able to get a boot to ball and at least force a boundary throw in when they were under a little bit of pressure there across that half forward line, the Tigers. So Scotty Turner having a spell on the bench. He started in one of the key defence posts for the Tigers. Brendan Gale doing the ruck work up against Capuano. Gale gets the front posse. Kicked away by Simpson. Nearly gathered by Abraham. He just slips the Harrison tackle. Gets it away to Grant. He looks and delivers towards half forward. And the mark is taken by Bell. Too far out to score. About 55 metres from goal, Peter Bell. Kicks the ball up towards half forward. Punched away there from Hewitt. Gathered by Hilton, confronted by Carey, going nowhere, Rory Hilton, and the umpire will ball it up about 20 metres from the Kangaroos' goal.
And Peter Bell put his head down to kick that. Corey McKernan was running towards the goals, and he didn't notice. He put his head down, and then he charged forward, leaving the Kangaroos no one to grab it.
It was a wild hot kick by Gaspar. James over the top of it. Powell, oh, they're in the dangerous area there. I'll be able to get out of it. Hilton's kick was also dangerous. Simpson didn't call it as a mark as he played on and got the moving Ryan Pagan's left foot kick. Standing his ground down there, Hilton had a few touches in the last few minutes. And now he can escape with a couple of bounces. He can keep going for a centre-half back. Good shepherding off the ball. Long kick to centre-half forward. Marinda not able to take it though. Look at Lee Colbert. Good strong kick, but can go anywhere.
Marinda's touched the ball once.
Callaway it is with the mark. High kick. Nothing unusual about that, I guess. At the back, Simpson cleaning up. Pike back to Simpson. Worked that pretty well. Goes off his wrong boot, and it wasn't a great kick, really. It must be a free kick to Brendan Gale.
You know, their bombing tactics aren't working. They should be looking at some alternative, just short chip kicks at the Tigers.
Well, it's a bit hard, I would think, Robbo, because the new coach has come in and he's asked them to play to a style of play. And, I mean, this is where you get it right for 4 or 5 weeks' time when we get to the day competition or the season proper.
Well, Colbert went to ground there. McKernan can get them going with a long kick. It's a pretty open forward line. That'll suit Carey. Oh, that was acrobatic stuff there by Shane Clayton. Carey over the top of it. Gaspar. Had good support at the end. Harrison's kick, couple of Tigers there, and one of them able to take the mark.
Bob, you mentioned Marinda. He's now off the ground, and Dragosevic is on now.
So 2-on-1 favouring the Kangaroos, but there's been a free kick paid, and it will go to Matthew Capuano for the Kangaroos between right half-back and right centre wing on the members' side here at Waverley. The Kangaroos 3-5-23 lead the Tigers one goal straight. Good mark taken by Cameron across the half back line. Now he's trying to stir something up down towards half forward. He kicks it out wide. No mark taken there by Richardson. Gathered by Daffy. Bumped off the ball by Pickett. Good hand pass. Wider still. Sets it up for Durkay. Durkay kicks back towards the centre half forward. How did he get that? He's just a magician, Wayne Carey. Kicks it forward, not wasting any time. Great punch away there by Rory Hilton. McKernan's high kick, nearly marking himself. Bounces awkwardly. Rogers gathers, goes down the wing, close to the boundary line. Out there is Bowden. He can't get there before the ball bounces away from J. Joel Bowden and over for a throw-in. Carey in front of Gasper. Well, Gasper must have thought that he was in a terrific position to punch the ball away there. Carey one arm and then the other. Free kick. It will go back to Clayton. Clayton for the Kangaroos to kick them to within scoring range.
And towards that man, Carey again. Off the ball, the umpire says free kick to Carey. Now the ball is on its way. What do you think, Jared?
Well, I'll have to have another look because I was just at the time it was played, just glancing across to my right-hand side where Jeff Geeshan, the new umpires coach, is observing play, not as a coach of the Tigers, but as a coach of the men in white. So
Gabe,
what do you think, Robert?
Gave as good as he got there, Carey, I would have thought. Could have been a play-on decision quite easily.
Well, he is within kicking distance. 45 out. Is it the first goal of the second quarter for the Kangaroos? Yes.
Kangaroos against the breeze, kicked by Wayne Carey. He's kicked two of the Kangaroos' four goals. Rory Hilton under pressure. Ball spills out to Bell. He's kicked, smothered off the boot, and then tackled. Front on by the Tigers player. Is it Nick Gaffey? It may have been Chaffee. Now Bell kicks the ball towards half forward. And no mark taken. Bell gets the ball away. Pike. Powell for Richmond. Bell swooping on the ball. Couldn't get the kick away. Gathered by Callaway. He's tackled from behind. A little too high, according to the umpire. And I must admit here that the umpire was in a terrific position to make that decision, Chris Mitchell. And it will go to Duncan Callaway. Evergreen, reliable defender for the Tigers. Kicks it out wide. Mark is taken by...
Must have just been a finger go over the shoulder, Robert. There certainly wasn't a lot there, and the Tigers a bit lucky to get out of that.
Well, it was Ben Holland who marked the ball, but Talbot receiving the free kick.
And going long, there's four Tigers there to try and spoil, but none of them could get a hand to it. And Capuano took it, well, almost uncontested.
Police pushed up to the forward line. Corey McKernan's just dropped back, having a bit of a run there. So they're really trying to rotate and confuse the Tiger big men. But of the two new players the Kangaroos have got on display at the moment, Lee Colbert and Ryan Pogan, I think the coach would be pretty pleased with the output of both.
Yeah, Colbert certainly looks a bigger player than he did at Geelong. Here's Capuano. Tell you what, you might have missed that. So they've certainly kept the Tigers in it with their kicking. 4-6 now. So one goal straight six, and it's Cameron who's going to bring them back into play.
You'll find Scotty Turner is about to come off the Tigers, straight onto Capuano.
Cameron kicks it out wide, gets Hilton, who's got a fair bit of space in front of him, goes quickly down towards his captain. It'll bounce over the head, Martin. Leading out away from Richardson and Holland, and got the handball away, got them clear. Good tackling. They got it away, and Pagan back to Martin. Starting to build something. Bell, pretty small, had to fly then. And Harrison takes the mark. And Harrison for the Tigers hasn't done a bad job. At nine possessions, kicks the ball out very wide, and Richardson doesn't take the mark. Bowden in support though. He's got a little bit of space and looks up and kicks it to 50. Martin again. This time he can't take the mark. Archer had his jumper held on to. And I think the umpire may have seen it. Yes, he did.
And just another one of the changes will be the advantage rule. If you think you're being hard done by at home and the umpire hasn't given you a free kick, no whistle this year will be blown to acknowledge a free kick if it's a clear advantage to the side offended against. The umpire is just going to wave his arm after the free kick has been infringed.
Clinton King for the Tigers. Now Richardson, tackled by Pike. Abraham to Clayton. Clayton quickly
ball intercepted down here in front of us by Brendan Gale, but absolutely stolen away by King. That's David King. Now the chances with Cameron. He's across the half-back line for the Tigers. Kicks it long, but kicks it straight to the opposition. Dropped the straight forward mark there did McKernan. Now the Tigers through Bowden get the ball towards Holland. He's well tackled. And a hand pass mocked up by Pike. Pike goes to Rawlings. Rawlings' kick is very ordinary. Hilton has done a pretty good job. Can't break the tackle. Gets the hand pass away out wide. Brendan Gale can straighten up and then kicks it high again directly towards goal. But it's 3-on-1 favouring the Kangaroos. Quickly onto it is Dragosevic. Snapshot by Mark Dragosevic is a Richmond goal.
At Bunnings Warehouse, you'll find Victoria's biggest home improvement range at the lowest prices every day. Like pack of two dichroic globes, $5. Plugs, 40-centimetre oscillating pedestal fan, $28.97. 1.8-metre galvanised ladder, $48.90. Spring tension chair in assorted patterns, $9.93. Norton Stronghold, 310-gram builder's adhesive, two for $4. And if you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Bunnings Warehouse!
Lowest prices are just the beginning.
So Mark Dragosevic kicks the second goal for the Tigers. And they're a chance to, well, be a bit more competitive and go into half-time, feeling a lot happier than they would have at the first break. King's kick, though, chopped off. Colbert got it away, and they're out of trouble for the moment. Into the centre of the ground. Brian Pagan over the top of it. He's caught. Good tackling by Cameron. Still over the top. Didn't actually try and pick it up, so he didn't infringe. Under pressure, that was a very quick handball from Powell. Well read by David King. Kicked it out of the air, and that was pretty clever. Well, Capuano, you should look on his face there as the ball went through his legs. Harrison clears it off the left boot.
Calthorpe on.
Push. And Benny Gale climbs to his feet. Just one mark tonight for Benny Gale. Three hit-outs and two kicks. Campbell under pressure. Just got rid of it in time. But it's all Kangaroos there. The handball from Rawlings. Oh, King got to his feet beautifully and escaped. Then kicked it long and strong. Oh, good lead, Capuano. Eyes for the footy.
Wayne Carey was the man. He feigned as if he was going to take the mark. And then he just stopped. The Tiger players looked at Wayne Carey and through came the second man.
It was nearly as good as the sting, wasn't it?
It was a beautiful bit of play,
yep.
Well, he's been fantastic tonight, Matthew Capuano. Started well early, that's for sure. Comes in and from 35 metres out. Kicks pretty well. He likes it. It's a goal.
You can go a long way looking for the lowest home improvement prices, only to find that things aren't always as they appear. So, if you want to avoid disappointment, go to Bunnings Warehouse. We don't have sales, just the lowest prices every day. And if you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Bunnings Warehouse!
Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Well, the Tigers have kicked two goals in the second term, but the Kangaroos have answered with two themselves, and they maintain that 24-point advantage. Harrison can't break away from Rawlings. A high kick, bounces rather awkwardly, knocked away by Blakey, gathered by Pickett. He straightens up and kicks in the direction of Carey. Oh. It's Capuano on this occasion, couldn't take the mark. Calthorpe's on the ground, gets the hand pass away to Abraham. Abraham's kick is very wide, bounces just inside the boundary line and then over for a throw-in in the right forward pocket for the Kangaroos, about 4 metres around from their goal.
And Zipper, a new recruit for the Kangaroos.
Yes, yeah, quite a bit about to make his debut for the Roos. Good luck, son, and Corey off.
They haven't done a bad job, have
he's
they?
He's a tall Kangaroos. Boy, I tell you.
They yeah, were premiers last year. They bring Big Spider Burton from the west. They get Lee Colbert and David Calthorpe. I mean, they've just strengthened their side.
Gary Durko back. They're pretty good at the footy business, Robert, aren't they?
Oh, it's fair. Look, what they've done over the summer has just been enormous. And on the scoreboard here, leading by 24 points, we've got 5 3/4 minutes left in the second term here. And the Kangaroos are into attack. In their right forward pocket, Carey doing the ruck work from behind Capuano on that occasion. Bell,
to Carey, and Carey scores just behind. So Carey, 2-2 in that scoreline for the Kangaroos. They've kicked 5-7, 37, and they lead Richmond by 25 points, the Tigers. 2 goals kicked by Mark Dragosevic and Joel Bowden.
So Leon Cameron's been busy tonight, kicking in. And there's a good one. Callaway, who's had 7 possessions, under the wing, Gale. Gee, they've got a lot of big men, haven't they, now? The Kangaroos, Rawlings feeding Pickett. The acceleration again off the King. It's a little sidestep, wasn't that good, off the left foot. And out of bounds.
Also, not only are they big in height, but just physically strong. I mean, these North boys have put on a bit of muscle over the pre-season.
And they're very disciplined too, aren't they? I mean, whenever Richmond have got a kick in the clear, there's never anyone sitting around or running down the ground trying to create a loose man, because they're just right, the Kangaroos, right onto them.
In the forward pocket, another chance for them. Here's Pagan giving space for his teammate. Blakey standing 40 metres out. Just lined the ball up straight and sends it through for another one.
Seven Nightly News, working to make your life better. Reporting your stories. Reporting on your community. Reporting for your life. Live, local, late breaking. Seven Nightly News with David Johnston and Anne Fullwood. Weeknights at 6.
Well, the good news is for Richmond fans, it's a round robin competition, the Ansett Cup. It's the way they're headed. They're going to need that to live another day. The Kangaroos starting off where they left off last year. Long kick from Adam Simpson this time as they go forward. Look at Big Spider. Got the handball out to King. King from 55 metres out. Another one. Well, just so quick out of the middle.
They're all running to Spider because that's where it started. And his ability as a ruckman, get that ball to the preferred player at ground level is going to be an advantage. He may have got some assistance there from Brendan Gale. And as always, Adam Simpson contributing. Terrific player, still a little bit unheralded. There was Spider pushing forward and getting involved in the play as well.
Well, he's got to be one of the most skillful, really tall players that we've seen over the last 20 years of AFL footy. And for the Kangaroos to pick him up is a terrific bonus. The Tigers get the ball close to their forward 50-metre line. That could be a mark paid to Ben Holland. He's been called to play on. Kicks it over his left shoulder. It bounces awkwardly. That's a push out, surely. And Archer is irate, to say the least. But it looked to me as though it was a fairly straightforward free kick to
he's got
the
50 metres as well. 50-metre
penalty. Yep, you're right there, Dipper. That's a push out, isn't it?
Yeah, and he kicked the ball away at the end. Dennis Pagan, generally, if there's a 50-metre paid, likes to talk to the players about it on the phone. And you'd be surprised if Ben Archer didn't get a bit of an early break before half-time.
I think there was an infamous one last year, wasn't there, where they had a few words?
There's a Kangaroo player now warming up on the bench here. We just to see what happens.
Brendan Gale should kick Richmond's third goal. He does. 4 minutes left in the first half. So at least that makes that gap look a little more realistic. There's 11 scoring shots the difference, 14 shots to the Kangaroos, 3 to Richmond, but a margin of 31 points.
Well, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Well, the action was Glenn Archer kicking the ball away, and Dennis Pagan, as he's so often done, straight to the phone and just having a chat to Glenn early in the piece.
Just about know what's going down the line, wouldn't you?
So the Kangaroos in command, 7-7-49.
You probably know what's going up the line as well.
3 straight 18. 4 minutes remaining in this second quarter. Spider Burton can do it all, rucking and roving. Simpson, Campbell just couldn't get boot to ball. He might get a free for a high tackle there. Campbell tonight,
Just four kicks, two handballs, two marks. And this man's been even quieter, Matthew Richardson. He's going to move it quickly, though, this time. Give the chance for Ottens and Holland. No mark paid, or was it?
That's got to be their key, surely, those big fellas down on the forward line, if they can get it to them
quickly.
Well, as quickly as they can, but more importantly, Jared, as close to one out as they can.
Well, they've done it that way. Well, Robbo, they got the ball out of the centre quickly, which is perhaps the first time for the Tigers this evening.
Benny Gale.
Two quick goals, keeps them in it.
Kicked one just a moment ago.
Archer back onto the ground.
Makes no mistake there. So Richmond go to four straight, 24. And keeping in touch, the Kangaroos, 7-7-49. Just over 3 minutes remaining in the second quarter.
Well, Colbert did particularly well there. He kept his man away. He knew where he was by virtue of his hands. And he kept his eyes on the ball. It was a great shot there. A player maintaining concentration on the ball. But Brendan Gale just had better positioning.
Jared, in the second term, Kangaroos 22 handballs to 5. They lead 41 to 35 kicks, trail 5 marks to 13. So Richmond obviously using the ball a little bit better and finding their teammates down the ground. Knight's kick was rather blind. Holland was held, was he? Or has the mark been paid? Pike with the footy, but it'll come back to Ben Holland. I was just thinking maybe if they could sneak another goal before half time. We've got 3 minutes left. Their efforts, will not have just gone unnoticed. Oh. They've tried very hard, but they've been outgunned so far in this first half. David Kingwell tackle, Rawlings handball, gathered by Pagan, back to Rawlings. Rawlings kick, lands across that half forward line, gathered by Harrison. The little kick is okay. Mark to Campbell, playing on quickly to Tawney. Tawney's kick towards half forward. Can they take a mark here? It's at the back of the pack. Chance for Richardson. Left foot snap. Trying to get onto it is Daffy. Oh, Nick. The left foot there was the opportunity, maybe. He kicked with the right. Hand pass was on too, Jared.
Well, a couple of the Tiger teammates thought so. And Spud feeling a bit of the pressure, but be a lot happier at halftime, I think, than he would be at quarter time, because we've seen a couple of goals come from the implementation of the style he's trying to teach the Tigers this year.
Yes, the last few minutes have been a lot more promising for Richmond. The kick in just outside 50. Ben Holland almost claimed that one as a mark. The umpire agrees. He wheels around and unloads. Big chance for the Tigers. He's in front. Benny Gale.
Well, the Kangaroos have stopped just at the moment, and Richmond have sensed that. And Brendan Gale's been very much the man to lead from the front. He's taken a couple of grabs, and he'll be lining up for his second goal in this term. Back, make that three.
Well, he is directly in front. And he's about 25 metres out when he'll kick it. And with just under 2 minutes remaining in that quarter, he's put it through for his third. So some hope for the Tigers going into the main break. Well, Dennis always looks that way, whether they're winning or losing. 7-7-49 to 5-1-31. And it's been the move of Benny Gale. Kicked them three goals, but it's really been up the ground, I guess, where they've improved a lot more, Jared.
Well, they're getting the ball forward, aren't they? Capuano, he's now down minding Brendan Gale. And marks this quarter, the Tigers are the ones that have got on top. They've taken 15. They're not handballing the ball, they're not chip kicking, so they're taking marks in the air, and their tall players are taking them some marks. And if you can get them grabbing the ball, generally you're kicking goals, and that was around the neck.
Well, the ball has been kicked out wide. Leading out there in the race was Durkay. Gang tackled there was Pagan. Leon Cameron appealing for the free kick. But the umpire will ball it up. The Kangaroos led by 23 points at quarter time. They lead by 18 close to half time. The ball on centre wing. Grant. Knights. Look away hand pass. Powell left it behind, but he was able to gather and then squeezes that little left foot kick out. Goes in towards the middle of the ground. Gathered by Pike. He's confronted by Tucknuts there. Bounces back to Kelthorpe. Kelthorpe kicks quickly towards half forward. Harrison under a bit of pressure. Back there to help out is Tawney. And he runs away from half back. Ooh. Kicks the ball into the middle of the ground. They've got to provide a contest. They did. He was never in the hunt, Ben Holland. And he marked. It's the 16th mark for the Tigers in this term. And he took it right away from Colbert. His kick towards full forward. Can the Tigers get another one? It's in the right hands. Nick Daffy, his kick. Falls short. They can still make something out of this. Brendan Gale can't get away with the football. And is he going to be penalised? He is. And it will go to the Kangaroos in their right back pocket. They get the ball out towards half back and it's taken there by Simpson.
I don't think Brendan Gale knew quite what to do there. No. He's on his back and the ball lopped in his hand. He didn't know whether to push it away, drag it in, knock it out to the boundary. Let's have a look here.
He wasn't allowed to do that.
Well, he was on his knees and he picked it up and that's why he was penalised.
Improved effort by the Tigers towards the end of that second quarter. They came home with a real run. Three goals to Benny Gale in the last 5 or 6 minutes. And here he is, the man of the moment. Gives them some hope. 5 goals, 1, 31, playing 7-7, 49.
And Ben Holland, well, he hasn't had a great impact yet. But I think if the Tigers can get the ball forward into that top 50 area a bit more quickly like they did in the last 10 minutes of that quarter, then he's going to get more opportunities. And we did have a look at David Kelthorpe there, as we see the bloke that's perhaps best on ground at the moment, Matthew Capuano, coming off the ground. Robert, you said that Dipper said most of the Kangaroos had put on some muscle. Well, David Kelthorpe looks serious to have lost a lot of weight. In fact, we'll have a look at him after 3 quarter time. It looks like he's pitched John Nichols' shorts, but he certainly looks a player for the Kangaroos.
So Richmond, some hope going into the main break. 18 points the difference.
Sid readies for action.
What do you think?
Should do the trick. Simple yet casually slutty.
But before tasting Dave's delights, a rich old man drops a bombshell.
He wants to give $10 million to your clinic.
David loses his research money and holds me personally responsible.
More bad news. He's a rich, dirty old man.
$10 million. You'll spend the next 48 hours together.
What's a girl to do?
Tell him you have a sister.
Providence, Wednesday on 7.
First came the wheel. Then, the power of the horse. At the dawn of a new millennium, we harnessed the stars. Come visit the stars. Tabcorp Interdom Melbourne 2000. A race odyssey. Book now through Ticketek.
For your chance to win one of 30 Ford cars, just collect the tokens every day in your paper, the Herald Sun.
It's my town, it's my paper.
How about those roos, eh? Another flag, mate. 20 wings for the year. Yep, see ya.
So you are a member?
Actually, I haven't got around to it yet.
I'd pick up the phone if I was you. Phone and become a Kangaroos member today.
Guyatt's Red Ribbon Sale is now in its last days, where you can get up to 24 months, no deposit, interest-free across our entire range. That's right, 24 months, no deposit, interest-free. But hurry, it must end this Sunday at Billy Guyatt's.
Whatever you want, whatever you want.
Still at $19.99 price, still the fuel-injected four-wheel drive Jimny with CD stereo and air conditioning. Still from $17.99, drive away today.
It's you, it's me, it's Suzuki.
This is the last Saturday you can afford to tell everyone everything at the lowest ever per minute STD rate. Only 1 cent per minute plus 40 cent connection fee. Telstra Easy Rates for every one of you.
When it comes to fun, nothing beats my family feast.
10 pieces of original recipe chicken served up with heaps of sides for just $17.95. Tomorrow from 8 a.m. till 10 p.m, you can get 15% off the mark price of everything at Target, plus convenient lay-by. So go down to your nearest Target store. But hurry. By Sunday, it'll all be off. With the biggest range of used cars parked daily, if it's not here, it's probably not for sale. melbournetradingpost.com.au.
Judgment Day. The verdict at the Valley this Saturday night, when Itadong superstars Courage Under Fire and Christian Cullen clash for the first time in the Eat Well, Live Well Victoria Cup.
Tabcorp. Itadong Melbourne 2000. Look now through Ticketek.
So, half-time at Waverley Park in the opening Ansett Cup match of 2000, and the Tigers coming back towards the end of that quarter and within 18 points at half-time. Another impressive performance, though, by the Kangaroos. Two goals to their skipper, Wayne Carey, Capuano, Blakey, Shoal, McKernan and King. And Benny Gale, it was, who kicked three goals towards the end of that quarter. And he's got three goals for the first half. Well, there's another Ansett Cup match taking place. That's in Cairns. It's between Sydney and Brisbane. Let's have a look at the first half highlights there.
Good play by the Swans, and they worked the ball on quickly. That was Allison, the Kangaroos recruit, down towards the forward pocket. A centering kick by Fitzgerald. Chance for the Swans to get the first score. Gord Johnson knocked the ball away in the path of goal. A chance here for Allison. He came to kick goals, and he's done it in the first minute. Another big throw-in. And a leap over the back is successful, but it's chopped off by Matthews for the Swans. Kicks towards midfield. The mark's there taken by Huskus. And a big chance for the Lions. A kick on the run is a beauty by Martin. Nick Martin, the new recruit from the Western Bulldogs. In between halfback and wing. Lachlan's got a bit of space at half forward, and you can't afford to give him space. He drives it well. Goods takes the mark and plays on. Adam Goods, the Norwich Rising Star last year. Power goes long. It's set up for Malloy, who comes down with it. No mark. It was Champion. Ball's knocked back to Johnson, who started in defence. Chris Johnson goals. And cleared out of the middle by Fosdyke. Ball knocked out of the front. Crouch gets the ball out to O'Loughlin. Perfect off the left with his disposal. And the mark's taken by Robbie Armat. Armat well within kicking distance.
And that's a great kick too, that.
It's a beauty. He had plenty of time to set himself and drive it long towards full forward. Where's Plugger Lockett? It comes to the front. Adam Goods gets his third. Out towards centre half forward. Here's Goods again. What a player. The hand pass is absolutely sensational. And on the run, the goal is kicked by Jude Bolton.
So half-time up there, and the Swans, perhaps surprisingly, leading comfortably by 29 points, 9-6-62, 5-1-31. And disappointing news for the Lions fans is that Craig Lambert has gone off the ground with a shoulder injury, so we wish him all the best. Well, a big second half coming up here, and we're back after the break to have a look at all the action. The Kangaroos leading by 18 points.
Heroes in close-up at the new Colonial Stadium. In season 2000, James Hurd will rejoin Michael Long to lead the Bombers to their greatest season ever. It will be total entertainment from beginning to end, and you could be right there, right in the action. Show your support by reserving your seats now. Call 9230-0390 for an application form. The Bombers are forever, but you should call now.
Optus Mobile makes it easy to catch up with family and friends with Yes Time. That's the time when the first 20 minutes of any call is free, between 8 p.m. and midnight every night, from one Optus Mobile digital to another, anywhere in Australia. And now, Yes Time has been extended to 2001. So go out and enjoy.
Biggest range of trucks,
Everything from utes and vans to trays and prime movers. At Budget, you'll always find the right truck for your needs. Budget drives your dollar further with 50% off Mondays and Tuesdays.
It's our biggest and best sale ever, Beaumont's sensational tile sale, 2,000.
Yes, right now, over 2,000 tonnes of tiles must go at crazy prices. That's every single tile in every store. Floor tiles from only $14.95 a metre. Plain heritage wall tiles, 33 cents each. Listello's from half price. And these Mediterranean floor tiles are only $18.95. Every single tile discounted to clear. Beaumont's sensational tile sale, 2,000. Don't miss it.
All the best.
All the best from Beaumont.
Beaumont Tiles.
You may see me on a coast road at night. You may see me in the first morning light. But if you want to know somebody, just look to you.
You're at company 20 degrees. You want some of the best surf we've had in years. 6 to 8 feet, but not many an experience. The offshore wind will blow you up.
Tomorrow from 8 a.m. till 10 p.m, you can get 15% off the mark price of everything at Target, plus convenient lay-by. So go down to your nearest Target store. But hurry. By Sunday, it'll all be off.
Oh, I love the desk. Look at the equipment, the view. I love it. Where did you find a job like this?
With over 6,000 jobs every week in the age classifieds, it's number one for employment.
Nice lights.
The Age, number one for classifieds.
Whatever you want, whatever you like, whatever you need, you pay your money and take your choice.
Billy Guyot's Red Ribbon Sale is now in its last days, where you can get up to 24 months, no deposit, interest-free across our entire range. That's right, 24 months, no deposit, interest-free. But hurry, it must end this Sunday at Billy Guyot's.
Whatever you want, whatever you want.
Half-time at Waverley Park, the Kangaroos 7-7-49, the Tigers 5-1-31. Well, Robert DiPierre, the medico, has got with him someone who's been involved with both clubs now with the Tigers. It's Darren Crocker. Dipper.
Yeah, thanks very much, Hutto. If one man knows how to beat the Kangaroos, this man does. And you're coaching against your old side as assistant coach of the Tigers.
Yeah, Dipper, it's a little bit strange to be up against the old rivals, but look, it's not too bad. We got ourselves back into the game towards the end of that quarter, so we go in at half-time. We can take a little bit out of that quarter and hopefully come out in the second half and go on with it.
Well, it makes a big difference if your tall forwards are taking marks, and obviously you're just trying to get the forwards one out.
Yeah, look, we're trying to bring the ball in as quickly as we possibly can into the forward line. Obviously, with the players of the calibre of Richardson, Ottens, we slipped Brendan Gale up there to take a couple of catches there towards the end of the quarter. With those sort of guys and that sort of height, why wouldn't you get in there, get it in there quickly?
Darren, it looks like you've got a new role for Nick Daffy in the forward line. We know he was a goal sneak up there a couple of years ago, but made a name for himself as a midfielder. But Spud looks like he's going to play him up close to goals.
Yeah, look, we've toed and froed about quite a few guys out there of what roles they're going to play. But Daff, we probably had in mind for him to play a little bit closer to goal, especially tonight. Unfortunately, we're probably not getting enough goals from in play. I think Dragosevich got one that quarter, but we're probably relying a little bit too heavily on the taller guys to take a few marks and kick goals. And I think this half, if we can just get a few guys, the Dragoseviches and the Proctors and Daff himself, a few guys getting goals from play will sort of make the job a lot easier.
Darren, have you seen the form of Leon Cameron and Clinton King in their first hit out for the Tigers?
Yeah, look, Leon's been terrific so far. He's a real general back there, directs the traffic. He hasn't really done too much wrong. Clinton's done a little bit in bursts, had a couple of spells off on the pine. But, I suppose he's one guy that, when he does go up forward and has a rest from playing on the ball, we're just probably looking for him to get a few crumbs and kick a few goals for us.
Capuano's been a bit of a hassle tonight.
Yeah, he has, definitely early. He was just dropping back and causing a bit of havoc. And it took a little while for our bigger guy who was playing on him, either Ottens or Gale, to understand, let's go back and try and man him up and drag him away from that hole in front of our forwards.
Darren, you looked in the first quarter to be pushing your half-forward line pretty deep and your wings floating across that half-back line. just to help them out, crowding the defence. Will you do that into the wind again in the third term?
Yeah, look, I think when you've got the master at centre-half forward up there, Wayne Carey, you don't want to give him too much room to work in. So the more space we can clog up there for him, the better off we're going to be. So I'd imagine that the wingers will still work deep and the half forwards will push up and play probably as extra wingmen.
And you would have been playing many times when opposition clubs were doing that to you when you had a North Melbourne jumper on. What would Dennis Pagan be saying to his charges now to try and beat that sort of tactic?
He'd be saying, Darren Crocker, you just lead up, don't kick it to him, kick it to the king.
Thanks for joining us, mate.
No
problem.
Well
done, and good luck for the second half.
Okay, no problems. Thank you.
Well, thanks to Dipper down there with Darren Crocker. Certainly a big job ahead for the Tigers in the second half. Well, time to have a look at a new trivia competition. Ansett Australia, the official airline of the AFL, is running an exciting competition during the 2000 Ansett Cup, and it's called the Ansett Club Membership Trivia Competition. All you have to do is join your club or be a current member and watch Seven Sports coverage of the Ansett Cup for the weekly membership trivia quiz contest. Ring the number 1300 367 001 and join your club or quote your 2000 membership number. The question for this week, Wayne Carey absolutely flew to take his mark in the 1998 Ansett Cup. But did he go on to kick the goal? That's the question we want to know. A, yes or B, no? And if you know the answer to that, you can ring 1300 367 001 and win some great prizes, which includes two people flying Ansett to four interstate games with their team during the home and away season, a double ticket to the Brownlow Medal and a night at the Hilton on the Park Hotel, and two tickets to your club's grand final breakfast and the 2000 grand final at the MCG, plus 16 runners-up prizes of a weekend trip to an interstate game, club merchandise, jacket and bag. So get on the phone now and see your team fly during the 2000 Ansett Cup and win. 1300 367 001 is the number to call. That's the new Ansett competition, so be involved in that. We've got the Ansett Cup, of course, at the moment, and the second half is coming your way on Seven Sport.
It's all about love.
We met about 9 months ago. I went shopping and I got in the car and I bumped into him.
Who was your driving instructor, Stevie Wonder?
It's all about insecurities.
Well, a sperm test involves testing your sperm.
Is it that kind, innit?
Yeah, there was plenty, thank you.
It's all about roses.
He told me that he loved me by shoving a rose up his bottom.
It's all about them and it's all about you.
Sex. She's mad for it.
Cold feet.
Why wouldn't she be?
Soon on Seven.
How about those roos, eh? Another flag, mate. 20 wings for the year. Yeah, see ya.
So you are a member?
Actually, I haven't got around to it yet.
I'd pick up the phone if I was you. Phone and become a Kangaroos member today.
This is the last Saturday you can afford to tell everyone everything at the lowest ever per minute STD rate. Only 1 cent per minute plus 40 cent connection fee. Telstra Easy Rates for every one of you.
You sleep better. You dream better. Sleepmaker, what dreams are made of.
So exciting, waking to a brand new day. Only Coca-Cola makes you feel this way. Time for some fun, come on, enjoy.
Coca-Cola, enjoy.
Enjoy the feeling that sparkles inside.
Every
minute, enjoy the ride. You know it's right, 'cause it's the real thing.
Coca-Cola,
taste all the pleasures that life's got to give. The
love the desk. Look at the equipment, the view. I love it. Where did you find a job like this?
With over 6,000 jobs every week in the Age Classifieds, it's number one for employment.
Nice lights.
The Age, number one for classifieds.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. Vacation, a grundy 1.8 CD and alloys, and a 1,000 rebates, 79.90. You can drive it away with a conditioner. Say Y2K, that's just a key. Key is for large effects. Airbag and aircon, $2,000 of X. That's extra features for which you don't have to pay. Say yes to key. Yeah!
Tomorrow from 8 a.m. till 10 p.m. you can get 15% off the mark price of everything at Target, plus convenient lay-by. So, go down to your nearest Target store. But hurry. By Sunday, it'll all be off.
Both teams on the ground then, as we prepare to start the second half of this opening season 2000 Ansett Cup match. It's the Kangaroos in front, 7-7-49 to 5-1-31. Jared, what do you think might transpire in this third quarter?
Well, you'd expect the Kangaroos, the power brokers of the team, as we said, the competition, as we said at the start of the telecast, Hutto, to go on and win this match. But I've been impressed with the Tigers. I think they're trying to implement the game plan of Danny Frawley. They've been let down up forward a little bit. They haven't been able to capitalise. Richo's been struggling, and Mark Merendo's only had the one touch, and he's starting on the bench. But you know, when you've got the likes of Wayne Carey and Corey McKernan up forward, it's pretty tough to stop. And now, they won't be embarrassed if they can remain competitive tonight, the Tigers, because there'll be few other clubs that can come out and knock off the Kangaroos.
Let's get down to Dipper.
Yeah, thanks very much, Hutto. Corey McKernan will be staying on the bench. Looks like he's just having a bit of a rest tonight. He caught a very bad injury on his nose in that first quarter. Interesting to see how Darren Crocker, what he said about his Tigers. Because they need to score this quarter just to keep in the hunt with the Kangaroos. And obviously this win, he's still playing havoc down there. He's still about a three-goal breeze, boys.
Is it cold down there, Dip?
No, it's not too bad, actually. The coffee and the blanket's quite nice.
Good
down
on
here.
You. Keep your eye on Ryan Pagan.
And also, Darren Crockett, you mentioned, can you just pump up the Tigers membership, make sure the membership are sold? So, and we know that Leon Daphne, Jared, our ex-president for the Tigers, was selling tickets out the front there. So go buy a couple of memberships off you.
You won his money today, I'm told. So why don't you go and buy one yourself, Dipper? But Ryan Pagan, son of Dennis, is now the Kangaroos' leading possession winner at halftime. So that's a pretty good debut for him.
We're underway in the second half, and Ottens gave the Tigers the first use of the ball through Callaway. The opposite number three, though, and that's Rawlings, gets the kick up to half forward. Well, this time, again, Carey had numbers to battle. And there's good pace. Tawney out of defence. Good attacking long kick to centre half forward. One-on-one battle, but Mickey Martin, he was just so solid there. And he goes short and finds Capuano. Capuano up onto the wing. And there's no one near Rawlings as he takes the mark. Brother Jade plays for the Hawks. Kicks this one deep inside 50. Good defensive spoil from the Tigers, but it's going to bounce up in North Melbourne's favour. King just... he had to wait for it a little bit too much then, and just a fraction sluggish, but Pike, good evasive skills. Almost kept it in, but not quite. And it's
hello,
out of bounds.
The North Bench buddy, Robert Scott, Durke, Burton, Clayton, Harvey, and Corey McKernan.
And what about that win for this quarter, do you think, Dipper?
The win, you said?
Yeah.
Yeah, still about three-goal breeze in the favour of the Kangaroos.
Up to half-back. Richmond trying to clear it. Gee, that was straight. Didn't even have to make a decision. That's straight over the boundary line.
Free kick's been played, though.
I think it was out in the full. Oh, no, the free kick in back to Shannon Grant, who kicks the ball off the left boot. And juggling effort from Tawney. Hilton looked behind. There was no one there. So he had time to measure the pass off. It was meant for Knights. Good spoil by Ryan Pagan. Tigers out of trouble just for the moment. Onto the wing. Proctor on the ground. And he's on the ground now, and the ball is over the line and out of bounds.
He's a tough campaigner, Martin Pike, isn't he? And Proctor,
still a bit unheralded, Robbo, though, isn't he? But he's been a great player for
the team. I think so. I think you know, you watch it pretty closely, and you acknowledge that. And I think most of your compatriots that follow it...
I think Capuano's in trouble, boys. He's coming off the ground. He's limping off the ground. I'll keep you up to date with it.
Thanks, Dipper.
And Burton to replace him.
But certainly Pike has been terrific. The kick towards half forward, and Blakey, another one of the contributors week in, week out for the Kangaroos, John Blakey, as we watch Matthew Capuano go to the bench. Play continuing. The kick goes towards half forward for the Kangaroos. Campbell gets away from Carey to Callaway. Callaway's kick, a bit of an up and under, and gives the Kangaroos defenders easy opportunity to put pressure on the Tiger forwards. Campbell's hand pass out wide is pretty good. Rogers, little left foot kick is all right, and Dragosevic is marked.
He just thought about going on then for a sec, didn't he?
Well, they're yet to score into the wind, the Tigers, and this is their best opportunity to date.
Kicked their first goal, Mark Dragosevic, after
play.
Coming on the ground.
Had a great year last year, really impressed in a couple of games. But I think the Tigers, if they're going to continue to bomb the ball to centre-half forward, have got to get Matthew Richardson out of the equation. He's just not that sort of player. He's more a running player that runs deep into the midfield and charges back rather than hanging around and taking pack marks and bringing the ball to ground.
Dragosevic with just his second kick. Oh, gee, that's pretty close. Right on the line. Now, it's either a goal or a mark, isn't
it? That's an interesting decision, that one. Said it was touched.
Well, the goal umpire indicating that no mark paid to Archer, a behind, so Pickett kicks it in, and Rawlings will kick it away for the Kangaroos.
And he kicks it up onto the wing. Hewitt just a little bit behind with the handball. That puts Shannon Grant into trouble. But he's going in after it again. And scrapping hard, cleaning up though Cameron. I reckon they had a pretty good debut here for the Tigers. Working well with Ottens. And streaming through the centre. That's a good kick, Martin and Richardson. Richardson wheeling back onto it. Can he pick it up? He just can't get away from the grasp of Mickey Martin. Little kick, went backwards. If he meant it was good. Went to Daffy. And that's a high one. Plenty of bruise underneath that. Archer, he'll stand his ground. Takes the mark and then runs. His kick not so flash. On the bounce through the middle. Knights, sliding effort. Good work by the Tigers with numbers. They're starting to build now. And plenty of numbers at centre-half forward. And Bowden it is that takes the mark. Richardson screaming for it back in the goal square. Martin directing traffic. Bowden not sure where to go. Richardson looking sideways.
He'll be kicking into a real strong breeze. I doubt if he can make the distance, even though we know he's a beautiful kick. And Miranda about to come on. Matthew Knight's off.
Well, he's got the fast bowler's run up.
Might fluke one, you never know.
He's gone right back. Now he's got to go for a pass. His space at half four. The kick was okay in the end. It wasn't exactly where he wanted it, but no one was near Daffy. So I guess given the position he was in, Jared, it was pretty good vision.
Yeah, I think they set it up pretty well, Hutto. It was quite clear that Nick Daffy thought he was going to get onto a bit of a set play there, and maybe they've done some work over the summer.
Well, this will certainly test him. The breeze, as Dipper said, is pretty strong. He starts well outside 50. The man on the mark's probably about 5 metres inside 50. And he kicks right from just inside. So it'll go very close. Oh, it was no trouble at all. First blood for the Tigers. Sorry, mate.
Interestingly, their captain, Matthew Knights.
He's injured. He got belted in the middle just in the lead-up to that play.
Yeah, well, sitting next to the football manager, Gary O'Sullivan, and we did see Dougie Hawkins down there on the bench. Dipper spoke to him before the game. Dougie Hawkins doing some skills work with the Tigers. Pike, here go the Tigers again. They're working industriously to keep the ball alive at half-forward. Campbell gets it back. Miranda, he hasn't had many touches. Kicked by Mark Miranda, right to the goal square. At least they've forced a behind. So well, another score to Richmond, and it is 10 points the margin in favour of the Kangaroos.
You want to see Matthew Knights about to come back on for the Tigers. They were just checking out his neck. He's okay. And Matthew Capuano, looks like he's hurt his groin. I don't think they'll risk him for the rest of the night. And nothing too serious, just keeping an eye on him.
And Brent Harvey's just come onto the ground at the expense of Winston Abraham.
Byron Pickett kicking into the outer side. Oh, lovely mark. And Harrison's done a pretty good job tonight, Jared.
Well, I think all the Tigers have lifted in this first 10 minutes of the third quarter, and they're looking pretty dangerous at the moment. Don't forget they're coming home with a pretty strong bruise.
13 possessions for Harrison. This time, though, they're clearing the ball out under the wing. Good spoil. Gale. Oh, sold the dummy. Benny, long kick to full forward. Richardson streaming. Ottens was flying as well. Gee, Ryan Pagan's done a terrific job. And so has Mick Martin. And Peter Bell just about always does. Keeps it out wide. King takes it. So a 10-point lead to the Kangaroos. Tawney versus Scholl. He was over the top of him, but he did it pretty well. Oh, that's a bit of a cruel bounce. Harvey played for the free kick. He did that well, didn't he? Propped, and he was certainly held on to.
So he's got Carey one out in the forward line, and that's what Pagan would be after.
Hilton was the man who had to go then. He made the spoil, and Tawney sees it safely through. So 7-8-50, plays 6-3-39. 11 and a half minutes to go in this third quarter.
And you would think there's an argument for a little bit of grappling there, Robbo, but the umpire thought it was within the rules and let it go on.
Campbell accepted the kick in, and then in turn, short pass to Rogers. Rogers able to kick quickly out towards the wing. Archer tackled, got the hand pass away. Hewitt for the Kangaroos, in towards the middle of the ground. Grant combines with Rawlings. Shannon Grant off the left, kicks the ball to full forward. Carey will kick a goal. He's just very good at that on the run, and he's popped it through. Well, he looks pretty composed, doesn't he, Danny Frawley, in his first game as coach of the Tigers. And there has been plenty happening on the positive side of the ledger, I'm sure, for Richmond so far in this game. Hilton to tidy up, gets his right foot to it, kicks it out wide. Cameron leading that awkward bouncing ball. He didn't have the football, did he? Simpson applied the tackle. Cameron, the recipient of the free kick.
Well, he picked it up and was well tackled, but that's what happens in footy. We all see it differently.
Touch of the old KBs there, maybe?
Well, the ball was knocked out by the pair, the force of the tackle, and that we should play on. But anyway, you've got to win them and wear them.
Ottens did pretty well in the end after making a bit of a meal of it. And the ball out of bounds.
Dirty shoulder, looks like, is he?
And that's big Spider Burton. Tallest man in the competition. Ball hurled back into play. As we see, Burton going down there, kick around the corner. Simpson coming through. There's a whistle. Well, it wasn't a case of the advantage.
Just after, I think it's Jason Tawney. No, it's Matthew Rogers who knocked the ball away. I think the umpire may have seen him to be just a little overzealous after the ball hit the ground. He's indicating there that he did have hold of his opponent's jumper, Brent Harvey.
Well, he wasted no time then and sent it long. Oh, that's a great pack mark. And that's Hewitt. He just stood his ground there. It seemed to be, well, what do you think of the Tigers' defensive effort there, Gerard?
Well, it wasn't good enough in the finish, was it, Hutto? Because they had enough people down there. But there was a bit of a push out on Harrison, it seemed. But
didn't seem to be enough height to go with Hewitt then.
It's been a big name all summer, Hewitt. Can they continue the flavour?
No punts in the air there. Hit the post. And 8-9-57 now to 6-3-39. Maybe put a bit too much slice on that one.
Cameron just a little indecisive, but eventually kicked it out wide. Still inside their defensive 50-metre area, the mark taken by Hilton. Hilton has had quite a few possessions, 12 to be exact. Coming up for kick number 12, one hand pass to accompany that. Gasper marks in front of Hewitt. Paid the mark just behind the wing. Darren Gasper, one of the key components of the Tiger defence, always takes one of the tall forwards.
And eventually, Richmond get the ball again, up towards half forward. Dragosevic overruns the ball. Daffy gathers. Little left foot kick by Nick Daffy, not bad. Bowden to straighten up. No, he doesn't. He goes with the right, kicks. And kicks inaccurately in the finish. Just may have had a little bit of space to straighten up and get onto his preferred left foot. But scores are behind for the Tigers. 6-4, plays 8-9, margin 17 points in favour of the Kangaroos. Pickett goes in short and finds Colbert.
What have you thought of Lee Colbert's performance, Jared? Four kicks, two handballs and just the one mark.
Well, he hasn't had a lot of the ball, Hutto, but across that half-back line, he's just been a solid performer, and I'm sure he'll get a run-up forward at various stages during the year, if not tonight.
Good chain of handballs, setting them up. Knights, couple to beat Benny Gale, almost did, provided a good contest, but Nick Daffy's lifted it.
Solo.
Oh, Mr. Bartman, we just love your premium life.
Who's your daddy, mama?
Oh, Mr. Bartman, take me to your...
Let's get it on.
Hello? Hello? Dal? Dal?
If you weren't into it, you should have just said so.
Lamb chop.
Good taste.
So, Richmond... mounting a challenge once again, margin just 11 points in favour of the Kangaroos. The Kangaroos led by 23 points at quarter time, 18 at half time, and now the margin back to 11 points, and there is an infringement. It will go the free kick to Burton, right in the middle of the ground. The big spider kicks it high and long towards half forward, goes to the back of the pack, Knights again, kicks it out wide. And it was pretty well done because there was no one out there really to the favour of the Tigers, bouncing away end on end away from David Kelthorpe. And you mentioned, Jared, that he looks pretty fit, David Kelthorpe.
I think he's done a lot of work, and they're very pleased with him at the Kangaroos. I'm speaking to a couple of the officials there in the last few weeks. They expect him to, if he remains injury free, to have a very big year. When he was a state player only 3 or 4 years ago, won an EJ Witten medal, he can really play.
Good quarter so far by the Tigers. Slightly dangerous, that kick from Cameron, bringing it back into the middle of play. Grant overran it. Gee, they got the momentum, having no Richmond through the middle. Back to Savage, lightning handball. Frees up Campbell, is within range. The kick, as you saw, smothered. Miranda played for it, he put it down. No, he's got free.
Well, was that Byron Pickett that came out and smothered Campbell's kick?
Freakish, wasn't it?
Oh, unbelievable.
It was almost the highlight of the evening tonight. So far.
Richardson leads into the pocket. He doubles back. He's gone for Holland. Had two to beat. And there's Pickett again. High clearing kick, but Richmond with the advantage. Here's Tivendale. Has the time. Can unload from about 60. He'll set it at the top of the goal square. Richard! No, couldn't take it. Ben Holland. Drag to ground. Daffy again. Oh, don't tell me. No, don't tell me.
It's a point.
Thanks, Tipper. Well, he certainly brought them to light. And here's another look at this. Great smother.
The Kangaroos are going to have to still have the taste for the battle if they're to win this match, because Richmond certainly believe they can.
That's got to be one of the most difficult things in footy, I reckon. Trying to run down a bloke coming front on and be prepared to get kicked in the face with the foot or the ball by Byron Pickett. Gasper marks the ball, then goes into the centre where Rogers has taken the mark. Rogers kicks the Tigers to within scoring range once again. And the crumbing, gee, he was nearly onto it again, Nick Daffy. A push out, though, from the marking contest. And it will go back to the Kangaroos at half back. And that free kick will be taken by Adam Simpson. And quite blatant there, the infringement against Matthew Richardson. The kick marked by Harvey. He's still not quite up to the wing, and decides to play on and kick the ball in towards centre-half forward. Two or three on one. Mark dropped by Hilton. Ball spills to the back, Cameron. He's been pretty good tidying up across that half-back line, Leon Cameron. And then with the left, does it beautifully. They've got a chance here. Tawney must get rid of the ball. Handball to your teammate who'd made terrific position. And that player was Campbell. He's had a couple of important possessions in the last few minutes. His kick not marked by Martin.
Spillage gathered. Now the ball in front of the Tiger goal. Chance here for Daffy. Pickett the player. Daffy to go back onto the football. Pickett got up off his feet and then applied the tackle and forced the ball out for a boundary throw-in. Still inside Richmond's forward 50. And another opportunity for the Tigers to kick a goal, which would bring the margin back to less than one goal after early in the game they trailed by 23 points.
Gee, it's gone up a cog, hasn't it, the pace. Bell kicks the ball and finds Harvey. 10 points the difference, Kangaroos in front.
And Abraham back onto the ground trying to give some speed to Hewitt off.
Bell fumbles and then gathers it. The Kangaroos have been a little quiet of late. Kicking with the breeze, that was clever. Durkay, there's Kelthorpe and there's Carey. Gasper right there with him. Plenty of Tiger fans out on that side of the ground. Darren Gasper.
Bit of a mismatch at the moment. Ryan Pager came off the ground, as you mentioned, Gerard, and he was playing on Knighta. Now Knight is picking up Clayton, and there's about 8 or 9 inches the difference in height there.
Ball thrown in just on 50. Otten's got the tap down, and they're going to get out of trouble, or are they? Good interception, putting the pressure on Clayton. He rode one tackle, it was a wobbly old kick. Carey down there, one out with Gasper, and it's out of bounds.
It's a couple of times that Rory Hilton's gone for that very short option coming out of defence, and it's been intercepted. And Danny Frawley, I'm sure, will be asking him to get the ball further out to a longer option.
I think from memory, had a terrific Ansett Cup last year. First couple of matches, Rory Hilton, then a disappointing season. And there he is taking the mark. Is he on cue?
He's one of the perhaps half a dozen players, Hutto, at the Tigers that really have got their footy careers on the line this future. They've got to establish themselves. The fellows like Proctor and Chaffee have been around a while. Tivendale's another one with some experience. And Jason Tawney, I would think, would be in that same category.
Well, the kick dropped short and we expect that because the breeze is blowing to the backs of the Kangaroos going to the left of screen in this third term, and you would think that 10 points may not be enough, although the Kangaroos in the second term kicking against the breeze kick 4 goals 2. The Tigers going to that left hand end in the second term kick 5 goals 1. Craig Scholl having a spell on the bench. Bowden gathers from the ruck contest, kicks it back towards the middle of the ground, and the mark is taken by Simpson. He plays on quickly, goes out wide. Player on his own out here is Colbert. Colbert looks and then delivers directly towards the full forward area between centre half forward and full forward. Cameron, hand pass. Hilton's got the chance again. He's had about 15 possessions across that full back line. Goes short. Rogers with the chance. Must get rid of it now. Goes towards half forward, running down is Archer, couldn't take the mark, pushed out, according to the umpire. And again, Jared, do you give the advantage there to the umpire because he was adjacent to the contest?
Well, he wouldn't have been able to see it. It was just looked like it was in the side. It was a push, but you are allowed to push in the side.
Short kick has been marked by Burton. Little left foot kick out wide. Abraham gathers, gets back onto the right and kicks the ball in towards half forward.
It's a high one. Over the head of Carey, over the head of, under the legs of Durkay, Callaway, Campbell. They've really bunched up well in defence in this quarter, but Durkay somehow got clear, and the kick was a beauty. And David Kelthorpe falls into the mark about 35 metres to 40 metres out directly in front.
Well, it's just his second kick coming up for the Kangaroos. It was brilliant play by Gary Durkay. He was almost legged and could have picked up a penalty, but it wasn't, no contact there, so he's got away with it.
Chance for a steadying goal for the Kangaroos here. Starts very right and stays that way. So a disappointing conversion. A disappointing conversion rate for most of the night for the Kangaroos. 8-10 playing 7-5.
18 scoring shots to 12, but Richmond have just been at the heels of the Kangaroos since quarter time. They've eaten away slowly at that advantage that the Kangaroos have built for themselves in the first term. Blakey gathers outside 50, bombs away, gets terrific distance, misses to the right.
Well, with 2 minutes to go in this quarter, the Tigers obviously desperately don't need the Kangaroos to kick another one before the break.
Well, that's pretty true, Anthony, as Joel Bowden takes his place on the bench. Short kick, and the mark has been taken by Callaway. Just a very awkward kicking style, Duncan Callaway. And again, pretty much up and under, but a good mark taken out at left half back by Ottens. 59 plays, 47, less than 2 minutes left in the term.
And just had found Rogers, has to kick quickly. Got an option though, no mark taken by Knights. There's the example of the new rule, smashing it out so he didn't get pinged. Got it to Tippendale, Richardson this time. Well, he had Mickey Martin in front of him and Byron Pickett behind him. All he needed there was Glenn Archer coming in for the perfect sandwich. And he stood his ground.
Gee, they don't need much from Matthew Richardson, really, to win this game, do they?
Well, if he kicks his goal, they're going to go in a three-quarter time with an enormous amount of momentum. Jeez, that would have been almost murderous if Glenn Archer had a bit of the area.
So Richardson on the boundary line and will kick from about 50 metres out exactly. It's a high kick. It's going across the face. They all gather and off hands out of bounds. A minute eight remaining in this quarter. And a 12-point lead to the Kangaroos, but Richmond have been terrific since really midway through that second quarter.
Well, they've got a chance here to score a goal if someone can pounce on this boundary throw-in. Must knock it clear. All players not to go to ground and then hand pass. And in there was Carey, able to gather but not break the tackle. So the umpire will ball it up. Only a matter of 25, maybe 30 metres from the Tigers' goal. A goal here could make it, just 6 points the margin. And we are very close to the three-quarter time break. Hand pass goes back to Knights. Can he thread his way through? He does. And then kicks nicely. And that's a little careless, that little push out. Daffy tried to make it look a little worse than it was, but, gee, in a situation like this, he's taken the mark. The push is nothing much in it, but you only need an umpire.
I think the Golden Globes were last week, weren't they, Robbo?
Well, you only need an umpire to be just a little pedantic in that circumstance, and you make a certainty of a goal, because here, there's still a risk. It's with Daffy, 45, maybe 40 metres out. He's made no mistake anyway. He didn't want the advantage. And he's kicked the goal for the Tigers. And more importantly, it is the goal right on the three-quarter time siren. So no chance for the Kangaroos to bounce back. And at three-quarter time, it is exactly 6 points the margin in favour of the Kangaroos. They lead 8-11 to 8-5.
Well, three goals to Nick Daffy. And singles to Dragosevic and Bowden. And Benny Gale also three goals. And for the Kangaroos, three goals to Wayne Carey, Scholl, Capuano and Blakey. What do you think, Jared?
Well, if the Tigers can keep up the pressure, they'll go and have a great victory. The first for Danny Frawley.
Only 6 points in it.
Hello, Jim Wilson. Andre Agassi will meet Yevgeny Kafelnikov in Sunday's final of the Australian Open. Agassi shooting a few baskets after that epic battle against Pete Sampras, who will be out of action for a month with an injured hip. And Australia's Renee Stubbs teams with Lisa Raymond to win the women's doubles. We look forward to your company over the weekend for both the women's and men's final.
Come one, come all to Harvey Norman's mammoth outdoor furniture liquidation sale. Over $3 million worth of Hartman Pacific stock must clear. Many items below normal invoice cost. Beach umbrella, $25. Country bench, $99. Classic Prestige 5-piece setting, $299. Bora 5-piece setting, $579. The 7-piece botany setting, red hot, $799. It's first in, best dressed, so don't miss out. Harvey Norman's mammoth outdoor furniture liquidation sale. On now.
Oh, I love the desk. Look at the equipment, the view. I love it. Where did you find a job like this?
With over 6,000 jobs every week in the Age Classifieds, it's number one for employment.
Nice lights.
The Age, number one for classifieds.
Fantastic start. Introducing the McFlurry. McDonald's soft serve with your choice of M&M's Minis, Oreos, Milo or Wonka Nerds mixed in. New McFlurry from McDonald's for a cool spin on your afternoon.
When you sleep better, you dream better. Sleepmaker, what dreams are made of.
Natural Nutrition Children's Health Supplements are just for kids, and they come in liquids, powders, and great-tasting robot-shaped tablets. Natural Nutrition, we've got kids' health needs covered.
Yes, Suzuki are still at 1999 prices. Still an award-winning four-cylinder or V6 Grand Vitara. Still with real four-wheel drive toughness. Still from 29,990. Drive away.
Suzuki. It's you. It's me. It's Suzuki.
If only it were this easy to avoid swimming where it's dangerous. It could be shallow, so you break your neck. There could be currents or underwater snags. So always check it's okay to swim with someone who knows. That way, you'll know it's safe to enjoy yourselves. Play it safe by the water.
So, a great last quarter to look forward to. The Tigers really streaming home. 8:11:59, the Kangaroos at three-quarter time. Richmond 8:5:53 to the goal kickers, Daffy and Brendan Gale, three goals each. Daffy well, doing well in that quarter. And Carey, three, the leading goal kicker for the Kangaroos. We can go down to Dipper very shortly, but let's check the scores first of all in the Brisbane-Sydney match at three-quarter time in Cairns. 12-7-79, the Swans, the Lions 8-2-50, so the Swans making a good fist of that game. There's Danny Frawley on scene. Let's go down to Dipper, and he has got the recently married Greg Miller, who's the chief executive of the Kangaroos.
Ah, thank you very much. To be sure, you got married in Dublin, did you? Congratulations.
Thanks, Dipper. Yeah, thanks, a few weeks ago.
No worries at all. We've got a bit of a game tonight.
Yeah, look, the Tigers have come back really hard, and, you know, to be only goal down, it's going to be quite a contest in the last quarter, for sure.
Now, the membership drive for the Kangaroos?
Oh, it's on in earnest, Dipper, and yeah. I just hope any of the Kangaroo supporters out there who thought about joining up, there's an opportunity. We've got people back at the club now, 1-800-007-667, if they can give us a call. I mean, it's very important to us. The strength in numbers is what it's all about.
And you've got a few games up in Sydney this year?
Yeah, we've got the five games, same as last year, Dipper, and we've got eight at Colonial and six at the MCG, so it's quite a spread.
Now, you've picked up some handy players, Lee Colbert, Spider Burton and Calthorpe. You know, the boys haven't had a big night tonight. Looking forward to a big season.
There's no doubt. There's some good recruits there, and they'll take their time to blend in, but they'll be fine.
And how's the Guinness, mate, all right?
I enjoyed a bit of it. That's good fun over there. Yeah, it was great.
Well, thanks for joining us, mate, and good luck for the rest of the season. And any tips on marriage, mate, come and see me. 20 years of it, I've had.
Yeah, well done, Dipper. Great job, 20 years.
Dipper with Greg Miller, and that number again if you're a Kangaroo supporter, 1-800-007-667 if you want to be a Kangaroos member. A great season, look forward ahead for the Kangaroos. What about the last quarter, Jarrett?
Well, look, the Kangaroos play into the wind as well as any side in the competition, and they're going to have to kick goals to win it because the Tigers, they'd be pretty bored. They would have gone into the three-quarter time break, Robbo, full of momentum, and Danny Frawley, usually a new coach, gets a win pretty early, and tonight be as good a night as any for him, I would think.
Now, Jared, his message at three-quarter time there, he just said to his players, look, it does take time, keep the pressure on. Now, just the old basic football stuff or whatever, nothing new is invented, obviously, but just some soft words spoken. I'm surprised, actually. I thought he might be out there with a big stick sort of smacking his players in a bit of gear.
A lot of time for that, Dipper. It's the first Ansett Cup match, and it's the battle will probably be won and lost in this middle.
Well, Spider Burton hasn't got any shorter, that's for sure, since he's gone to the Kangaroos. Out of the middle, Bell on the left boot. And it's not a bad kick either, and finds Clayton. What an impressive player he was for them last year. He's kicked that one pretty high. Big pack of players to contend. Tivendale stayed down his handball. Almost missed the mark. Powell just slew up the hand a little bit, and therefore the kick wasn't exactly where he wanted it to go. Out to the boundary line. King came through, just brushed aside. his opponent and gave it to Simpson. Very nonchalant looking kick from Simpson. Didn't really line them up. And as a result.
Hello, can I just give you the benches now for the Kangaroos? Abraham Capuano, as I said, he was injured before. Not taking a risk with him for the rest of the night. Durke, Scholl, Corey McKernan and Ryan Pagan for the Kangaroos.
It's very important. I was going to make mention of this before the siren started, though it was blown to start the last quarter. It's very important that Richmond keep their noses to the grindstone. That three-quarter time break, they had everything flowing.
Yep.
And it's just given North or the Kangaroos a chance to maybe restructure, resettle. But these boys have just got to keep going as hard as they did at the end of the third term and make sure they score the first goal of the last quarter. Tawney running through half-back centre wing, kicks the ball in the direction of Miranda, gathered there by Holland, kicks it away to Campbell, or hand passes it away rather to Campbell. His kick lands right in the forward pocket area. Colbert with the ball, confronted by Campbell, and just a little friendly hello.
I think they're pretty good mates, actually, those two.
And for Richmond boys, Chaffee, Bowden, King, James, Proctor and Scotty Turner.
7 points the margin in favour of the Kangaroos early in the last term. Burton, big left fist to it. Archer at the front. Ball just not able to be grasped there by Glenn Archer. And it'll be thrown in about 40 metres around from the Richmond goal.
Having said they're good mates, I think it was Campbell was having a bit of a belt with a teammate last week in a practice match, wasn't he?
Yes, Mark Miranda and himself put on a bit of a display. Still trying to find out who won on points, but... back to this match, and Adam Simpson's actually the only player in the forward half for the Kangaroos.
Burton to Pike. Pike was...
what was that?
Not much room to get that kick away. Blakey in turn to Scott. Scott quickly onto his boot. Cameron from behind. Can he control the football? Pressure applied by Simpson. Ball goes back towards Blakey. His kick nearly marked in the pocket there. For the Kangaroos, gathered by Harvey. Snapshot for goal by Brent Harvey. Just misses off to the right. So the Kangaroos have got the first two scores of the last term. They were just behinds, but they've made the play in the early part of the last term. They lead 8-13 to 8-5, an 8-point margin.
And they're going with just a very small forward line at the moment. You saw there Harvey and Scott and Simpson trying to combine with Carey well up the ground.
Tigers breaking away from the huddle. It was Harrison who took it. And went long, doubling back Richardson, probably more his style. Couldn't quite grab onto it, but he's breaking open a few packs. Daffy, long kick, right to the square, almost the mark. And another behind goes on the board, 8-6-54 to 8-13-61. So back to that 7-point margin.
It'll be a big cheer from these young kids if the Tigers can get the next goal, I'm sure.
Pickett kicks in down the middle.
Off one step. It's pretty relaxed style of kicking.
Now David King, he's going very wide to try and get himself some space to deliver the ball. It was a pretty high kick. Gaspar, the spoil, and Clayton it was that pretty much belted that deliberately over the boundary line and out of bounds. So 8-13 to 8-6. Still 15 minutes remaining in this match. A cool night at Waverley. Tigers coming home with the breeze. They've been terrific after an onslaught, particularly in the second quarter from the Kangaroos. They didn't score in the first quarter, Richmond. Now Callaway and Robert Scott. Great survivor of the Kangaroos, Robert Scott. A handball from Bell. Missed the mark. Knights trying to clear the pack. Tivendale, long kick. Standing his ground, Miranda went over his head. Richardson again couldn't get clean hands. Dragosevic, a high one, tough one for Richo that. Had three to break, he might get a bit of assistance from the umpire. And Mickey went like this.
The person coming in from the front, I think, was it? Was it? I think he was the infringer. Would you consider that?
Yeah, no, spot on with it.
And a long kick from Richardson right towards the teeth of goal. It's got good distance on it. Almost made it through. So they're peppering away 8-7-55 to 8-13-61 now.
Still looking quite composed, the Tigers coach Danny Frawley and Pickett to kick in. goes short to Archer. Archer, in turn, drops it a little short. Tivendale, but a good mark from behind that Richmond player to Harvey. Away to that athletic running ability of David King. His kicky towards the centre of the ground. Calthorpe, but Thorpe goes towards goal. It may bounce Rich end on end and go through for a behind.
Advantage was paid there, and the umpire didn't blow the whistle. He just waved his hand. The Kangaroos, as we often see, without anybody in that forward line. And Carey, stride for stride with Gasper, was a dead even race.
Knights accepts the kick in. He's at right half back.
And typically long, Matthew Knights kick. Richardson behind, though, that time. Martin just too strong for him. And he kicks it out wide to the wing. It really, the style hasn't suited Richo tonight, Gerard, or is he just having an off night?
A bit of both, I think. Don't take anything away from Mick Martin. He's had an extraordinary night, sensational across the half back line.
Well, Rawlings, long kick, and Otten's it was that flew a little early. Rogers, looks like he was trying to pass it to the boundary umpire. Well, they were marking it last year. The umpires that time, the boundary umpire let it go and it went out of bounds.
Improvement in the game, do you think, Cutter?
Oh, well, added some interest to it.
Good evening to Peter Carey, wherever you are.
8-14, 62 plays, 8-7, 55. Three goals each to Daffy and Brendan Gale for the Tigers. Tawny over the top.
Dragan Sevic's been good since he's been on. He's been important in this final too.
Left foot kick that time. Set it up. Oh, Richardson, that time he knocked the ball to the front of the pack. No one there, but Kangaroos. Bell and Archer combining well. Through the middle, Clayton's kick is a shocker. Straight to Ottens. On the overlap, Daffy got to run hard at it. He does do that. Can he break clear? Got some space, 60 metres out into the square. Benny Gales kick three. And now he's got the tag for four.
Well, it was costly mistake there by, I think it was Scott Clayton, whose kick was poor, and then he was just knocked out of the contest in a follow-up. And with the result of this kick, we'll see the Tigers in front for the first time. In fact, they'll be just a point behind, and they'll have a big sniff.
As I said, Brendan Gale has kicked three goals tonight. You can see there, seven kicks. And the Tigers within one.
At Bunnings Warehouse, you'll find Victoria's biggest home improvement range at the lowest prices every day. Like 600mm yard broom, $12. 7kg Jumbuck Hotshots barbecue fuel, 2 for $13. Azito Lawn Shark electric grass trimmer, $58.98. Pope 2-hour tap timer, $18.23. 200 by 50mm F-clamps, 2 for $6. And if you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Bunnings Warehouse!
Lowest prices are just the beginning.
Oh, he's been terrific, Brendan Gale. He's been a lion-hearted stalwart for the Tigers over many years, and he's kicked four goals in this first Ansett Cup match at Waverley for season 2000. Campbell to get the Tigers forward once again, and that's a mark. A terrific mark taken by Chaffee. Gives away the hand pass to Knights. Knights, the vision. Pretty good. Well done, Matthew Knights. But Daffy... Well, he started quietly, but this will be 17th kick, and it may be his fourth goal, and could give the Tigers the lead.
Well, it's a good move, this one, from Danny Frawley, to get another genuine goal kicker up close to the sticks. Tigers last year always had about the same possessions, and they were perhaps handball received mad at various stages, but they weren't kicking winning scores. Tonight, this one goes through, they're going to be tough to stop.
Daffy going for goal number four. Should get the distance, but not the accuracy. Disappointing result for Nick Daffy. He's kicked three goals, but he's also kicked a couple of behinds. Not saying that they could have been goals, but, well, after 17 kicks, he could have had the Tigers in front.
King kicks out wide. Tough one for Rawlings. In the end, he gave it up. Bowden over the top of it. Did he pick it up when he was on the ground? He's going to get a free.
Well, he's got the free for in the back.
If he takes his time, boys, he can kick this goal because he's with the breeze. is going across the ground. All he has to do is guide it between the goalpost and that point post and will drift through.
I get the feeling Richo would rather him get it for the ball down quicker than he did.
I think so, yeah.
Geez, body language sometimes ordinary, isn't it, Matthew?
Well, this could put the Tigers in front. He is a long way out with the breeze behind him. Bowden coming in from about 55. It's long. It is very long.
Right on the line. What a great kick. He heard you dip it. But he needed about another 3 centimetres.
A terrific kick then. He knew that he could kick the distance. That's why he sent him one back. He's like the pinch hitter for the Tigers at the moment.
Well, let's have a look at Matthew Richardson's reaction. It's one of frustration. He's been kept at just 6 possessions tonight, only 3 marks. He's only kicked a behind. Maybe he'll kick the winning goal, though. Might be his night, but his moment might be still there.
When you're going ordinary, Jared, you've just got to keep your chin up, keep your spirits up, because you are one of 18 out there, and you must do that little small percentage things to give your players a little flip they're looking for. Carey has marked the ball. Now, he's a long way down the ground.
Brent Harvey now at full forward. One out in the square. One out in the circle.
Chance here for the Kangaroos. Desperate stuff by Ottens on Martin Pike. Still a chance. Hewitt trying to knock it forward. Rawlings combining with Ryan Pagan. Pagan the hand pass, then the receiver. Kick forward. Grant jumped early. Hilton to take possession across halfback and go directly towards goal. One out contest, Holland and Archer. Richardson left it behind. Martin desperate. Still Mickey Martin, knocks it clear. Daffy and Chaffee.
Well, that was just brilliant work by Mickey Martin, because instinct and 30 years of football would have told him to pick the ball up, but he had the composure
look at Danny.
The new rule, and he just knocked it out. Welcome to coaching, Danny Frawley.
Yeah, the face getting redder. Not sure if the hair's going grey yet. That'll come, Danny. 1 point the difference. Richmond in front. We've got 9 minutes to go in this match. What a great start to the Ansett Cup 2000. Bouncing ball, Timmenbach. He did that well. Really freed up Hilton. He's got a man inboard. You better watch out. It's Rogers. He's got another one if he wants him. No, he's going to go to Longa.
Yeah, for Richard.
Where is he? There he is. He's climbing high. Couldn't take it. Bell, well tackled. Ball to ground, not well tackled. Advantage paid. Taken by Lee Colbert. Carey. Oh, 5 bites. Have to just about pay that. Come on, give it to him, he says. He just demands the ball, doesn't he, at all times, Wayne Carey. They're 1 point down. Starting to look a bit serious in the North camp. Long kick, Scholl props. And takes the mark.
Scholl just came off the bench straight into that position and just took the right position then.
Well, it's experience of a couple of premierships coming off the bench, Dipper, but he's still got to put this one through. And it looks as if they're down McKernan and also down Capuano at the moment, the Kangaroos. So there's they're running short of numbers in the area that gave them the dominance early.
Scholl's kicking from 40. And started it out to the right and couldn't bring it back enough. So, we are all tied up. So we look at Carey taking that mark again. 63, each of two.
Kick in, not marked by Ottens, but he does well for a big fellow. Bumped off the ball by Calthorpe. Little kick by Burton was clever. And eventually, Calthorpe to Blakey. Back he goes to Scholl. Scholl across his left shoulder, kicks the ball to right in front of the goal, dangerous area. Handball by Rawlings, gathered by Knights, away to Hilton. Hilton, who's been terrific, forced to kick with the left, no one really to kick to, so just in front there of Durkay and Dragosevic. The ball goes over for a boundary throw-in. Pike, Simpson, Hewitt in the background, Capuano presently benched. Maybe Matthew Capuano, a slight injury, we feel. Burton to do the ruck work up against Ottens. Scores level, just 7 minutes left in the term. Knights, that was good play because he was going to have to kick with the right, and he gave it to the preferred right footer in Rogers.
Oh,
that was a terrific effort by Pickett. Sprawled on the ground, able to get the hand pass away to King. King leaves it behind. Still a contest in the middle of the ground.
Chaffee Campbell, gathered by Daffy, got the left foot kick away to half forward. Chance here for Richardson. Hand pass, not really all that effective. Pickett, ball spills wide. Dragosevic standing his ground was Colbert. And at least Lee Colbert has forced a ball up right on the 50-metre line, favouring the Tigers.
At some of the performances of Byron Pickett in the last 5 minutes, just he seems to find a space through a pack that no other man can.
6.5 minutes remaining. The ball on defensive 50 and a free kick picked out there. Goes to Ryan Pagan.
Kangaroos need a bit of a lift from Wayne Keir. He's had just 6 kicks since quarter time. Two of those have been goals, mind you, but they need a couple to win this match.
Bowden, gee, Knights has really lifted the Tigers. That time he went without the footy, so did Campbell. Free kick to Campbell, I think. I reckon he might have just been held on to. Chris Mitchell agrees.
Well, some fresh legs about to come on for the Tigers. A guy who can find the ball, and Clifton King I'm talking about.
Kick up towards full forward. Colbert got back, good spoil. Robert Scott across the body. Out to half back. Plenty of space out here for the Kangaroos. Harvey.
Got Blakey over the top all alone.
That's where he goes.
Great kick.
Yeah, right to space. Blakey able to run into it, but the Tigers have pushed back. We've got a couple of loose men filling up the hole, so he centres it. Big leap. Carey unable to take the mark.
Great kick, and he kicked it exactly where Wayne Carey was pointing. If we get another look at it, you'll see that Wayne Carey, for at least 10 seconds before John Blakey got rid of that ball, was nominating top of the square, 20 metres out. It was a brilliant kick and an even better mark.
Gee, good mark, wasn't it, from Abraham? Standing his ground in front, so a chance to put the Roos in front. 7 possessions tonight, that's his first mark. And has not kicked a goal.
Well, they've been inaccurate all evening, and that's the sort of thing.
Well, Harrison back
up
on, and he's all by himself on the side here.
Just been spotted now, but he's going to switch to the other side of the ground.
And it's Hilton who's made position. Must get it just inside the line. He does. Able to gather. No one to kick to. Backing back and does it pretty well in the finish. Squeezes the kick away close to the line, but it's gathered well, very well by Bell. And he runs away after one bounce. Kicks the ball to within scoring range. Back there is Bowden. Big punch away. Gathered by Harvey. Little kick. Did that go the required distance? It did, according to the umpire. And the mark has been paid to Craig Scholl. Scholl goes long towards the square. It's going to cover the players there. It is a goal. Good kick by Scholl. Seven points the advantage for the Kangaroos. So the challenge thrown down to the Tigers once again. They did have the lead earlier in this term. Simpson's kick goes out towards the right half forward area. It'll be gathered here by Hilton. He could have ducked back the other way. He didn't have the pressure that maybe he thought he had from behind and kicked it straight over the line. The free kick down in front of us here at right half forward taken by Scholl.
The man that kicked the last goal looks for Carey. That's a terrific grab by Gaspar. Just his fourth mark for the night.
I don't think anybody would question Rory Hilton's attack on the footy and his commitment to the ball, but he's just got to, over the next 12 months, improve his disposal, which has been a bit costly tonight.
One of the wing goes to kick. It's a bit scrappy. Val, oh, he floated that one pretty well. Harvey had to take on the troops. Did that come off a boot? No. Out of bounds.
Off the head, mate.
Thanks, Dipper. 7 points the difference. The Kangaroos, 9-16-70. Richmond, 9-9-63. 3 minutes and 45 seconds remaining. So Tigers have got to get a move on. They'll know that. Otten's kick went nowhere. Ryan Pagan done an excellent job. Oh, Carey, well, you talked about it, Jared. He had to kick a couple, you said, for North.
So strong, O'Hara. He just keeps Gasper out with his left hand. He's done it a number of times today. And just watch him use his left arm to get the position. He's actually just behind here. Gasper leaning in and then has the composure and the ability to snaffle it with the other hand. There's no substitute for raw ability, Robbo, is there?
And the unbelievable confidence in that raw ability.
From 50 metres exactly, Wayne Carey lines them up and... Whoa!
That's a goal.
It is now.
Well, yeah, it is now.
At Bunnings Warehouse, our qualified tradespeople will give you all the right advice for all your home improvement needs. Like Kitab 25-litre black hobby box, $3.98. Three-piece paint roller kit, $6.90. 4-litre Dulux X10 weather shield, $46.90. 550ml hardpoint saw, $12.92. Rich Grow 25-litre potting mix, two for $4. And if you happen to find a cheaper price on a stocked item, we'll beat it by 10%.
Bunnings Warehouse.
Lowest prices are just the beginning.
So the Kangaroos, some crucial goals as we close in on the end of this match. And they're away now to a 13-point lead, and suddenly they've got the momentum back.
Still 3 minutes, Adolf. They can get one down there quickly, the Tigers. They're not out of it.
Fell over there, Jason Tawney, and was allowed to get the hand pass away. And it's at half forward. Hand pass goes back towards the centre where Dragosevic was the intended recipient, but gathered by Abraham, and his kick puts the Kangaroos back into attack once again. Carey, the ability to gather and then kick short. Cameron, Gasper back to Cameron. Cameron to assess and then delivers into the centre. Callaway, important possession here for the Tigers. Well done, Bell.
Bell
still got the footy.
Bell is his range of cream in this final quarter. He has been the one player that's lifted in the middle for the Kangaroos. And how many times do we call it Peter Bell winning the ball back for the Kangaroos?
Well, it's wide for the Tigers and the kick goes back in towards centre-half forward proper. Chance to run onto this. It's Dragosevic being pressured by Scott. Now he's got to hold the ball or knock it clear. And he's been penalised. So Scott will take the free kick. You spoke about Peter Bell. Just then, Gerrity's had four possessions, but it's the other work, the chasing and the dispossessing work that you have been impressed with.
I think he's just he's a real champion. He's still also a little bit understated, but he's just one of the best midfielders this competition has.
Well, Brendan Gale will kick Richmond right down to the front of their goal. Dragosevic can't break away. Chance here, and the kick by Ben Holland has just missed off to the right. Scores are behind.
Probably had more time than he knew. Probably could have picked it up, but I guess he was just trying to do the quick thing, quick thinking. 10-16, 76 to 9-10, 64. And a minute and a half remaining. It'll be tough now for the Tigers. They would have loved to have kicked that one, that's for sure. And Lauren's going to go for a bit of a stroll.
Going long and wide. Hit the boundary, a famous man once said, in a 66 grand final. It's still appropriate here.
Altons takes the mark. And he goes short to... just couldn't take it. And pace just seemed to have gone out of the game just a fraction now. Benny Gale pushing and struggling and trying. Knights will try and open it up with a handball. Campbell, nowhere to go. Did pretty well. Bang it onto the boot. And Lee Colbert concedes the behind as we're into the last minute now. And the Tigers' job, just about impossible. 9-11, 65 to 10-16, 76. 54 seconds remaining in this match. But a terrific contest for the first Ansett Cup match of 2000.
Hilton, it is, getting another possession. And quickly onto his boot, Daffy. That's holding the man against Nick Daffy, surely. And the free kick will be taken. No, it is the advantage. So it was Clayton's free kick. Now, what's going to happen? It is going to come back because maybe the umpire thought there was no advantage there for the Kangaroos. So it'll go all the way back to the right back pocket area where that holding the man infringement against Nick Daffy, the free kick will be taken by Clayton. You can see the seconds remaining in the match. So it'll be a win for the Kangaroos.
They lead right now by 11 points. They were headed in this last term by the Tigers when Brendan Gale kicked his fourth goal, but the Kangaroos have hit back hard. Brendan Gale has marked the ball. He's at left half forward and he gets his kick away. Certainly within scoring range. Richardson bustled out of position there by Mickey Martin. He is just the epitome of discipline, Mickey Martin. And he's been rock solid again in this match. It has seen his side, the Kangaroos, led by Wayne Carey, come out over the top of the Tigers. Just a small margin, 11 points, but it is the margin that counts because the Kangaroos post their first victory for season 2000 in this Ansett Cup. 10-16-76, Richmond 9-11-65. And for the winners, Wayne Carey kicked 3, John Blakey 2 and Craig Scholl 2. And for the Tigers, Brendan Gale kicked 4 and Nick Daffy kicked 3.
Well, both sides went into the match pretty much full strength. And I think at the end of it, Danny Frawley would be pretty pleased with what he got out of it. He would have been bitterly disappointed, I think, getting so close in that final quarter not to go on and record a victory. But they were up against last year's premiers, who did just enough to take the points and let us all know that they're going to be there at the end of the season next year.
So the Kangaroos prevailing here at Waverley.